I did that.
Whatever. That was just great, Kelly.
Turn the volume down slowly.
That was great.
I faded it out. The song wasn't even over.
Yes, I know.
That was great, Kelly.
You did a good job.
Just another podcast. You did great. So I'm going to episode this one. Yes. Episode 113. We got a special guest back with us, but even more than that, my daughter's in the studio. Sienna, say goodbye. Don't worry about it. We got Caitlin behind the camera, holding it down.
Mm-hmm.
You want to be Miss Monique, Mama Monique? No?
Mama
Monique. You're not here?
She's not here.
She's invisible. Willie Beam is in the building. Liddy's here. Hey. And I brought back somebody. I know y'all are in the comments just saying you're just here for Miss Brownstone. Well, welcome back. Hit subscribe. Where's my button to make sure y'all hit subscribe, man? Welcome back. Hit subscribe. Miss Brownstone, welcome back. Oh, I'm going to get you your applause, too. What, you want some gunshots or something?
I like the gunshots, though.
Scared my daughter spinning the block.
Real bad gal.
113, where we want to start at? Oh, I already said it. If I get caught cheating, that don't mean I don't love you.
Right.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Technically.
I agree with that.
Very technically.
It's pressure for me today. Usually I could go home later and be like, I know I said this shit, but she'll see it like 2 weeks later. And I'd be like, that was on a pod. I don't even remember saying that. But now she's sitting right here.
You can't argue with me with stuff I say on the radio.
That Martin episode one.
Classic.
Ladies.
Yes.
I have a clip to play. Do y'all want to talk about Division's song? This song's been out for a couple weeks. That was actually the first time I actually listened to like the lyrics. And I was here. I was this before you got here. These are facts. You knew who I was when you got here.
That's bullshit.
These are facts. Shit, that's why you here.
But you could say the same for women, though.
Sometimes.
No. It is. Like, the way he's talking, he's making it known, like, you knew that women wanted me, you know that they find me appealing, you knew mm-hmm, I was that mm-hmm. nigga before you got here. Mm-hmm. I could have been that girl before I got with you. So, does that mean I should be doing the same thing? So, based off the chorus, I understood what he was getting at. But once I listened mm-hmm. to the lyrics, I'm like, no, this is toxic. And if that's what y'all gonna be promoting, then women gonna be on the same time.
Women are already on the same time.
Always.
But it's not known. When we cheat, you know,
we don't know.
Just throwing that on the table, if that's the case. Like,
always.
Nah, we know y'all be cheating. We know y'all are better at it. We know men are more complicit in the act. They be like, yo, if you fucking with me, and I'm the side dude, I'm going to stay the side dude. See, I actually like being the side dude.
But I think there are certain guys, and I'm not saying that that's like anybody here, but I think what I hear in the song is there are certain relationships where certain people call it, you know, someone of like an NBA player, rapper, or whatever. He's talking about himself. He's a musician. That there is almost this idea that, hey, you know the kind of lifestyle I have when you decide to enter into a relationship with me. And some women knowingly go into spaces knowing that cheating is possible. And you hear women all the time say, hey, I'm okay with him doing that as long as this, and this is in place. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And so when you listen to the song, he's just reminding the woman in the song, like, yo, you know what it was when we got in a relationship. There's not many people that think, hey, I'm with this multimillionaire and he's just faithful to me. That's most women probably have a certain understanding around.
And they do, because they always say, what, different tax bracket, different.
Absolutely.
So I mean, they do know.
And it's sometimes it's implied. And then I think there's rules to cheating. We all agree that certain men do cheat and they get certain passes than other men that get cheat. Everybody has different tolerance levels for anything. And it doesn't have to just be cheating. It could be a whole different type of act. But to say that the same rules apply from guy to guy to guy is ridiculous. That's not even smart dating. You should have unique rules based on the value that you believe the guy brings to your life.
That's true, but I guess because I'm hearing the words that he's saying in the beginning versus the chorus, I feel like if you're going to be an actor, musician, whatever, and you got these whole bunch of women, maybe y'all should have sat down and had that conversation. You feel me? Because it's kind of like he's saying, well, it is what it is, and you knew this, but if that's how he's going to be that bold to say it on the track, he should have had a conversation with the girl. And told her, you know.
We don't know what conversation happened.
But if it was a conversation, then it wouldn't be considered cheating.
No, that's not true. he's basically reminding you of whatever the experience was when you got here, and just saying, hey, don't be mad. You knew that this was a could be a possibility when you got into the relationship. You knew that I had a high demand of women. You know that I move around. You know that I sing whatever. He's just reminding you of what you got yourself into. And it doesn't even have to be cheating. Cheating is just what's good for the song. It could be multiples of things. Mm-hmm. But most of the time, you, women always say, oh, show what the man, his actions, not his words. That means this nigga showed you that in the beginning. Mm-hmm. He did what he thought he was going to do, and now he's singing a song to remind you what you knew in the beginning. Don't have your feelings hurt. You knew what he was going to bring to the table from the jump.
Would you rather cry in a Corolla or a foreign?
I'd rather cry. Listen, I
get it. That's in the song. I got to ask. I have to ask. What do you rather do?
Before she answered that, though, it's like, for me, it's like, people are going to say stuff that sounds good on the surface. They're going to say things that don't make them look a certain way until you're in it. Mm-hmm. Until Jeff Bezos really pulls up, and we're going to really see your logic then. Everybody's going to try to diss the guy. I don't care about this. I don't care about that. Mm-hmm. Until you're in it. Until you're in that situation. Mm-hmm. Until you're really approached. The most women who say they wouldn't, because they've never been approached to be in it. So it's easy to criticize something you've never been a part of.
And to flip the coin, right? If I'm a man, if Drake comes and he's going, like, hey, Caitlin, what's up? And she skates off with Drake, I'm going to be like, damn. I know the game. That's Drake.
Mm-hmm. Especially somebody who teaches a whole platform on hypergamy, like, you gotta do
but
that.
But my thing is, I say on my platform that cheating is not a deal breaker to me, but right. What I don't like is the way he's carrying it in the song. I think that it shouldn't have been like that. Like, it just sounds like when he's saying in the song, like, you knew I was that nigga, so hey, like, what? I'd rather you kind of have the conversation with me instead of
That wouldn't have been a dope song. I get what you're saying.
Right.
But at the end of the day, yes, it does sound kind of boisterous in the song, but that's what makes the song dope. But I think if you really go at the actual meaning of what he's trying to communicate, and it doesn't have to be cheating, I'm going to say that again, is he's saying what we all agree. Look what the man is actually doing versus his words. And there are certain implied risk for every kind of guy that you deal with. Regular guys, dusties, $100,000 guys, there's certain things. You're going to have one set of problems with one guy and another set of problems with another. And we all decide what problems we're willing to accept. Mm-hmm. That's for every guy. He's saying in his life, you knew one of the potential risks to dating him was he might fuck other bitches. And he did it.
And he also said that you wouldn't want me if other women didn't want me.
Oh, that is a fact.
But women know that.
That's a fact.
I mean, we know that. I guess I just don't like the fact that it's just
like... Why don't they like hearing the truth?
I don't like that. The way the delivery of it, the way it is, I just don't like it.
I was going to say that. I mean, this is the honesty that women ask for. You don't get to choose how it's given to you.
Lydia, from somebody who's been on all parts of life, women always value a guy that other women want. It's since they were no. And I'm gonna tell you why. Look at every romantic movie. Look at how it's always written up. I don't care if it's fucking Great Gatsby, Romeo and Juliet, whatever. The guy in every scene that's ever written is the guy that every girl wants.
Boomerang.
And this idea that we all have is that this guy has options, but he chooses you. That makes women feel good. You want to feel that you're in a room full of women. The guy chooses you. You don't want no guy that nobody wants. Every girl has been with a guy, and just like guys know with girls, I don't care what guys say, we know with certain girls that are on our arm that get stares, and we know certain girls that no guy is checking for. And the same way with you. You know you've been with a nigga that girl's like, damn, he's fine. And then you've been with a guy who might be successful, but nobody's even checking for him. It's a different energy. That is true.
I second the motion. I don't know what else to say. He said it all. It's a fact.
Like I said, I understand it. I'm not saying I don't agree with it. I just don't like the delivery of it. And I just wonder, like, if men are, I feel like in this generation now, men are like bad bitches. You get what I'm saying? Like, they just want to put out there, like, yeah, everybody want me. They got this idea of certain things.
Yeah, no.
She's spinning the block or
no? That was a good one, though.
How I feel. Like, they got some, like, weird thing in their mind that they're the prize. They have to be chased. Everybody want me. And they got this idea that women are desperate. So we like, pick me. And if you're going to be that cocky and put on a track, then another woman should be as cocky and do the same thing.
But there are. Women's been cocky since the beginning of time. What are you talking about?
The whole genre of rap music about these cocky.
100%.
They talk about cocky about finessing dudes, yes. Fucking every dude they want to fuck, off. I don't need you for this, that, and the third.
We grew up in an era where one of the most popular tracks is I Don't Want No Scrubs. That's the most cockiest fucking line. Like, what are you talking about? You literally did a whole song of all the things you don't want from a man.
Facts.
Yeah, we cocky in that department. We not don't. We not talking about us cheating though. Women don't talk about women, us cheating.
Oh. Red light special. This is your my little secret. Yeah. What are you talking dreams. About? He's mine. Fucking, you might have had him once, but I got women been talking that shit for years. What are you
these
talking
are all your
about?
Old school tracks.
Oh, she's too young. She don't know.
No, that's all she listens to, bro. She don't know who Division is.
Exactly. Women been talking that shit for years.
For eons.
Come on.
For decades.
We're just better at delivery.
No, y'all
I just
aren't.
Wanna.
Men
I just wanna
accept. Men are more accepting of whatever you're talking about.
No, but no, I
hear you. That's fine. We're having a discussion about delivery right now.
But the delivery
she
is
was saying that she heard the song and what he was saying, and she's with it. But I just don't like the way it was said.
But the song wouldn't be cool if he didn't deliver that way. But this is what I'm saying though. I do agree with the idea of like. I think it's funny, like men being bad bitches. That's funny. I think that's a way for women to throw shots at men who start to learn to value their own selves, right? Because nobody had a problem when women said, chase me, do this for me, get on a knee, do all this kind of shit for me. But if a man gives out his standards and his desires and what he wants the expectation, now he's acting like a bitch. Even the idea of telling a man he's acting like a bitch, he's saying, oh, that's for me to be and that's for you not to be. And then if a man then says, hey, I want this and that from a woman, now all of a sudden he's a bitch. That's how women try to demasculate a man for wanting the same
I
thing.
I seen a post, I don't know if y'all seen it, but it was a dude in his, he put on his Twitter how almost what you just said, right? Like, I want a girl that everybody wants. I don't want no girl that nobody's checking for, right? And then all the girls is in his comments airing him out. Because he can't say, he was like, fuck her personality. I want to wake up with a 10. Mm-hmm. I can't wake up next, I don't care about her personality. Mm-hmm. That's his preference.
Yeah. All men want a 10.
I'm not saying there's anything wrong.
Yeah.
I'm not saying anything wrong with men having standards. I'm not saying that. Because at the end of the day, when it came to my platform, I watched how men move. And I was like, all right, so I'm going to do it like this. So I'm not saying there's anything wrong with having standards. But when I say that y'all act like bad bitches, it's because of a lot of content.
You
got
to change that, y'all. Them.
Well, men, certain men, act like bad bitches is because of the content that's being pushed out now. So it got y'all thinking that way. But you act like that, but then you say you want a certain type of woman. So if you want a certain type of woman, the woman that's going to chase you, that's going to be pursuing you, is not going to be a feminine woman. So what do you want?
Yeah, I disagree,
don't think so.
I got to push back on that.
You don't think so?
Because there was a whole, like Willie said, there's a whole generation of women that was taught to be the dude, basically. So now dudes is like, no, I don't got
to. Yeah,
gotta,
but she just had a woman in her feminine.
Yeah, if you want a woman in her feminine, but, she's not going to pursue you.
Right.
No, I mean, she's not. But
not
I think,
overtly.
I think most of the time what you see is, and this is just my personal experience, is women don't get into that role until you show them like, yo, you can do that with me. It's a certain level of like, trust and compassion and all this different shit that you got to put into the mix before she even softens up to that point.
But all women are gonna all women are gonna chase at some point. So what are you saying, in the beginning or middle or the end? A woman, if I'm in a relationship with a woman and she starts to feel me slip, she's going to chase. If a woman's at the end of the relationship, she's gonna chase. If a woman's in the beginning, once I've already started to date her, she's gonna chase. So what are we saying, chasing like in the beginning, like the actual pursuing of a relationship?
Yeah, I don't think a woman should be pursuing a man. And also, like back to what you just said, if you was to pull away, she's gonna chase. Honestly, women, if a nigga pull away from you, he go ghost. Fuck them, because I'm not doing all that.
That's not
like,
true.
That's just how that's how I feel. Ask you.
She's saying that's not true. She didn't say it's not true. She's just saying that's not.
I'm saying it does happen.
Women happens
do,
all the time.
When you pull away, a woman do come forward. And that happens when men, like, vice versa. But what I'm getting at is, I don't think women should do that. I think they should ask you what's going on. Why have you been distant? But if you're not going to talk about it, we can't come to a common ground. You don't want to, then all right, whatever.
And I guess I'm saying I disagree. I think every woman should evaluate their desired outcome of that relationship and how much energy they want to put into it. If you want to have these flat standards that all men, if they do this, you do this, you're going to be alone for a long fucking time. Every man shouldn't get treated the exact same. On your value and what you think of that man, you should decide if I do want to step forward, I should step back. The dusty nigga, definitely. Yo, peace. You want to step away? Peace. Yeah. But the nigga that's actually worth something, you might have to step it up a little bit. You might have to come forward. There's not a single relationship. Not a single relationship. You can talk to any woman who's been in a healthy relationship and say, yo, where there's times where I could have stepped back and I didn't. Hey, I actually love this guy. I've seen how this guy shows up. When a woman has experience and they experience a real guy to come into their space, they know when to hold them and when to fold them. And those are the kind of women you want to be with. They know when they're around a nigga that's worth coming towards.
That's a poker reference for y'all that didn't get it.
That makes sense.
They might not have got it.
But once again, I stand on that, because at some point you need to reciprocate the energy. If I'm putting the effort showing you I'm into you and you not reciprocating it, then fuck it.
Totally agree.
I'm not going to keep chasing you. I don't want to chase, period. I'm going to show you I'm into you. I like to, I don't shoot my shot.
I think it's the wording. Like, I think what Willie said is accurate, and I think you don't like the word chase.
No, but I agree.
But if he's doing what he's supposed to do and you're showing up like you're supposed to, and he might veer off, you might put in a little extra energy, which is chasing in a way. That's what men do when a woman they want. They got to go do stuff to present.
And all I'm saying is don't have this linear approach to relationships, because every guy should deserve a different energy. I do agree with you. There mm-hmm. maybe 80% of men, including me, deserves for you to be like, hey, I'm gonna do A, B, C, and D, and I'm gonna walk away. All I'm saying is save room for that 20% who's worth a little bit more. That's all I'm saying.
I respect mm-hmm. that.
Mm-hmm. Well,
well said.
To piggyback on that, we got a clip. Miss Brownstone, did I introduce you as Miss Brownstone or something else?
Miss, I will hope so. I believe so, right? I believe that's what he said.
Names in my phone. I just thought about
you on camera.
Okay. Yeah. I always do government names for real. I'm not a nicknamey type person. Miss Brownstone sent me this clip. Let's play it. Who is this, Miss Brownstone?
I don't know who you. Oh, Star.
Star.
She is the owner of Cookie Wash. Sweet Cookie Wash.
Oh.
Sweet Cookie. She sell vagina products. Yeah. And if y'all want a discount, I got a discount code. He could put in the link so I get some money.
So her business is called Cookie Wash, and it's all about the
about female products.
I respect that.
Yeah.
Great hygiene. It goes a long way.
With the man who makes your life easier, treats you like a princess, just enhances your life. But he gonna be cheating. Are you leaving? I am not. And I used the wrong word. It's not cheating, I should have said. It's monogamy. Because it's you guys coming to an agreement that this person might see other people, but he is still providing you your best life. You can be with a guy you love and he's faithful to you, but he doesn't give enough affection. He's rude. He has poor leadership or money management skills. He's not supportive. He's not fun. And for me, got a blast. I'll be with the guy that has multiple women and he treats me how I like it and we have a ball. Mm-hmm. You always have to assess risk versus reward in this life. You can't just live your life solely on emotions or you will be out here fucked up.
Exactly what I just said.
Mm. Well, he says that's what exactly you just said.
No, but before, I do want to react to that, though, real quick, because I do think, and I know some women, like, even the idea of monogamy or being with some, like, one-on-one, like, I do think there's some women out there that really desire, like, one man, one woman. I also think...
There's some men, too.
Yeah, but what I'm saying is I actually think sometimes women also have societal pressure for monogamy. Like, mm-hmm. they can't, like, they don't even want to go tell their friends that, yeah, I'm with Fred, and Fred is with me, but on Fridays and Saturdays, he's with Jan. Like, that would just, like, a woman will look at you like you're crazy.
Yeah.
And I think some women, like, when I'm listening to her talk, most women rather protect their image and be with a guy who does all those other things not so well, just so that they can go in front of their whoever, their friends, their sisters, whoever, and be like, hey, Fred's faithful to me, though.
Yeah.
Like, they care more about that than they really care about the outcome.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but even if you're a woman and you did say, like, oh, I'm with Fred and he's with so-and-so and so-and-so, I don't even think, from that societal pressure, I wouldn't want to tell it to my girls because I dare one of you hoes. I don't want him fucking with my friends. You know what I'm saying? Right. But
yeah, that's the way women y'all gotta
are, and I don't like it, it shouldn't be that way, but the way women are, like, you could, sometimes if a woman knows a door is cracked, she's gonna try and get in there.
How common?
No matter how close
friends,
to you.
How common does that happen?
You already see the value in your man.
It happens a lot. Friends will try your man.
If you have some females, it depends on the girl. Cause you have a female that's a friend, right? And her man don't treat her. Her man treat her, you know. And she see how your dude, what he got going on, how he treats you. Now she'll start asking you questions about your relationship or how's your sex life. And she trying to slowly get in there. So there are women like that because they're miserable in their relationship. And they feel like because he treats you a certain type of way that I'm going to get the same treatment. But that's not true.
That's so never true. I don't even know if people think that's a thing. Happen.
Or they're just lonely.
Or they want to get their ass whooped.
That too.
Yeah.
That's what it really is.
But I like that clip by Star. I do because I think that you do have to, like, put in consideration all the things that come when you do break up with somebody, right? So I have been in that situation, so I understand that. But I think that if it's a conversation had up front, then it's not cheating. Like, if we know that, then it's not cheating. I know what I got myself into. I also believe that I don't have to tell my family and my friends what goes on in my relationship. Like, if we sharing a certain type of, you know, experience or whatever together, that's what we agree on, that's what we don't agree on. I, you know? Like, I have friends that I say when my boyfriend, whatever, I'm going to take them to the strip club. Some of my friends be like, you going to do that? You basically open the door for him to cheat on you. Just because you can't handle that don't mean I can't. So it really does depend.
What are y'all thoughts on what Willie was saying, though? Like, from if your man wants to explore open relationship, polyamory, polygamy, whatever the case may be, what's y'all's thought process around that? Like, I think that's... I think it's just conversation. I think not even just societal pressures, but just... Like, that was the norm. That's how we grew up. That's what we saw. That's what we were told. Yeah. Even though your grandpa had a family down the street, mm-hmm. you know what I'm saying? Everybody was told, like, you get with one person, you stay with one person. And nowadays, I think people are waking up and being like, I don't know how realistic that really is. Mm-hmm. What are y'all thoughts?
I think it's very realistic to just be with one person. It's realistic is the word that we're using right now. It is realistic. It happens. Mm-hmm. It's a real thing, right? But it's less common, for sure. Mm-hmm. And I think that nowadays, like, I'm open to any conversation that you want to have. Like, we could talk about it. I don't know if we're going to agree. I don't know what it is. But I also feel like if a woman wants honesty, she has a moral obligation to make sure that talking to her is a safe space. Mm-hmm. So he should feel comfortable to bring that information to me so we can talk about it. You shouldn't be flying off the handle whenever he tries to open up what's in his head and talk to you, because that right there will leave you alone.
Most times, women will, though. That's the funny thing.
No. They're like, you want a threesome?
You want to fuck up that bitch?
You want to be with other people? Even if you're like, but you can too. They're like, you want to be with other people?
You got to make it a safe space.
They missed that part. You're not getting no safe space.
Make it a safe space. He should be able to be honest with you, no matter what honesty means, because honesty isn't always what you like to hear.
But this is the thing. I do agree with Ms. Brownstone in the fact that how we define cheating or any type of deception should be whatever rules we agree upon. Yes. And they shouldn't be tied to monogamy, even though they are. Like, for me, cheating or deception is really saying, hey, what did we agree upon, or what did I think you would do, or whatever we created, and then you stepping outside of that. Like, for me, like, that's even how I define trust. Yeah, like, at the end of the day, is I feel somebody breaks my trust is when they do something out of alignment to what I expected. Not saying that you did something with another guy. It's like, oh, damn, I didn't expect that from you. That's when
even
you
dudes, like, if it's a dude that I'm cool with and he do some shit, you're like, what the hell?
Yeah, I didn't see that one coming.
Man, him, the trust not you. Broken.
Yeah.
I'll say, you know, my mother ain't here, so I hope this will make you uncomfortable. But I'll say this, right?
I'm going to say she uncomfortable. Yeah, like, you're not uncomfortable already.
Right? No, because you asked about the whole poly thing and threesomes. My opinion is, like, I have been with women, right? I would never be in a relationship with a woman because they too damn emotional for me. But I have had my fun, right? And I'm, you know, me making exotic dancewear and stuff like that, I'm around women, you know what I'm saying? So with that being said, I feel like if I was in a relationship with somebody because I wouldn't mind having a threesome like once in a while, whatever, then that's cool with me. If that's something that me and him understand. Mm-hmm. Now, as for the whole thing of like having a whole girlfriend, nah. Because I wouldn't want the girl to get treated the same way I'm being treated. Like, if I find out you even bought her a Happy Meal, I'm going to flip out. So that's just not going to work for me. But if we're going to
treat her. You said that because Lydia got this McDonald's cup on my
nah, but if we're going to treat her like, this going to sound messed up, like a toy or something like that. Like, oh, baby, just bring that out to get it spicy. Then cool. But to be on some junk like, oh, I got to go, you know, change her tire. Or I got to pick up from work. And you do that with me? Mm-mm. Now I got to get rid of her. So,
y'all in these tires.
Not going to happen.
It's a big deal.
And women get, even what? In the poly relationship, there is jealousy. No matter how much they try to make it seem like it's not, it isn't. Because there's going to be one woman that was there before the next one that know that man in and out. And she's not going to show that second girl that, because she don't want that second girl to take her spot. You know what I mean? So there's jealousy in there. Even when he might hug you a little bit longer than he hug her, it's a scene. Mm-hmm. I don't want to deal with that.
What are y'all's... Because most of my viewers, even since you've been on, the percentages have shifted a little bit, but and some of the clips. But what is the advice y'all would give young men that want to broach that conversation with their lady? Caitlin, you can chime in too. That's funny, right? Well, I'm creating content. Okay. Y'all leave me alone.
That want to approach the conversation of poly?
Any of that. Hey, I want to explore threesomes. Okay. I want to explore open. I want to whatever he wants to explore. How would you say he should?
Okay, let me cover the basics before you go in, right? Mm-hmm. The most obvious things. We have to respect timing, right? There is a time and a place. And I feel like the time and the place should be where you're both calm, you have alone time, you can focus on the conversation, but not before or directly after sex. I don't know why. I can't explain it, but not then. Okay?
I thought she maybe. Was like mid-argument. You like, and you don't even let me have a threesome.
No, but I honestly agree with Lydia. Like, as a man, that's when you're... That's
mind
when
is going those places, not then.
That's where y'all going at?
Put that back in your brain.
Lydia's right, though.
Men's actually right. Like, no, hey, if it was one more...
It'll be after. It'll be like probably like before. You're like, yo.
Right. Like, yeah, if it's before sex, you probably might not have sex. And then if it's after sex, she's going to be like, what the fuck? Was you satisfied just then?
Just from Lydia's comment, I would be like, yo, I would be like, yo, tell also, me your past right now.
Like you said,
I've never thought in my head to
I
do
did.
That.
I have.
Because you're aligned with her. I'm like, what is wrong with you? So you was like, Lydia, yeah. Afterwards, you was like, damn, this would have been
not
super.
After. Right. I wouldn't do it after.
So before you was like.
It'd be like, if you laying in bed, you know it's about to get popping, right. You talking kind of like crazy.
You had a girl in mind already?
No, you just more like, I'm with Lydia. It's more like what
hey,
do you,
so what if we call I know what so
it is. Exactly.
Nah,
it's not like that. It's more like you. That's when you would bring it up.
No.
Because even the idea of the all visualization, right.
A moment okay, of honesty.
I don't think you bring it up.
We've had some of these conversations, and it never been during sex. If now, not is at dinner a good
definitely
time?
Definitely not during. Sometimes
we'd be at dinner, and I'd be like, you know,
yo, I'd rather be yo, at dinner.
Okay, yeah. Right, no, but wait. No, because we can say that majority of our intimate sexual conversations happen during pillow talk, and pillow talk happens before sex. Or so after. Lydia's right. I mean, after I'm like,
I'm y'all pillow talk before.
No, I'm ready to go to sleep. Yeah,
pillow talk after.
See, I'm going to sleep afterwards. So I ain't,
all right, yeah. but disrespect the timing of it, okay. And the other person.
So I got to do it away
mind.
From sex.
Yes.
So he's a like, wild boy. I told
like,
you.
Yo, you got to be at lunch like, hey, I know where work
no.
is really.
That's the other thing I was going to say. Also, respect their state of mind. Don't come talking to me about you wanting to fuck whoever else when I'm thinking about work or I'm thinking about whatever.
I'm trying to figure out when are you.
I'm trying to tell you. It needs to be
Lydia gave me
a
all
time
blackout
of day
dates.
That is calm. Quiet, and we're both in like that peaceful state of mind, like the time that you would normally go sit on the couch and watch TV
in the
together.
Pool at the Maldives. No, it was a moment where we were just staring at the private island, and we were just at peace. And I should have been like,
"Yo, but see, that's
we
why I
really add another."
I count that.
You could have. That might have been.
No,
island.
We were so peaceful.
See, I count that as pre-sex because I'm like, okay, that's what leads up to it because eventually it's pre-vibes.
It was the middle of the day. The whole trip
Willie,
was a vibe. Why are you right.
Not
staring
every vibe leads to sex. That, like, no. When you're just having a chill. That's how
y'all ain't never been with Willie Moore.
No, I'm just saying that's the time to
every
do
vibe.
It. Bro, Willie said every saying, vibe. Bro, I'm not saying that. I'm
Miss Brownstone or Caitlin, which one of y'all want to chime in on how a man should broach this conversation?
I don't think you should even talk about it if your girl... Like, if you want it to be like a threesome. If your girl's not bisexual, she's not into girls, I wouldn't bring it up. But I think the perfect time would be like if y'all at a bar or in a restaurant and you see somebody or you see her looking... Because we look at butt, too. Well, at least I do. I look at other women's butts and her body. You be like, oh, you think she cute? You know what I'm saying? Like, how you feel about women? Or then you had that conversation. After sex, it'll turn... Yeah, I would set it
so
up. Or
me,
I would
I can
take,
never have this conversation.
No. Ask her first is what she's
saying. Yeah, like if it's at a club or a bar, or take her to the strip club and see how she interact with the women and then slide it on in there. You get what I'm saying? That's how I would do it.
The
but don't ever
move.
Say that you already know the girl you want.
Don't do that.
Because then
no,
I'm going to think
never
that,
do that. That's a
yeah,
mistake.
You know what I mean? And give it her, give make it seem like she can pick the girl. You get what I'm saying?
No, you should.
No, but that's what I hate because women always do that and then try to ask you, do you already have a girl like in mind? That's like
because we want to know if you already got
it. No, but first of all, no guy is gonna like voluntarily give up a woman that they would want to have a threesome with. That's the stupidest thing you can do. And second of all, you don't want to do it with someone that like is in your realm or bubble. That's gonna create a very toxic dynamic. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it has to be a random. Has to be a throwaway. Like she said, 100%.
Caitlin, did you want to chime in?
I feel like we had this conversation in the airport coming back from Mexico. Remember?
We've had a lot of conversations.
Should have had.
Well, when we talked about it, I felt like.
Well, no, because to her point, I know Caitlin doesn't really like girls.
Yeah,
right.
We're not going to be in the. We're not in the gym, and a girl walks by, and she's like, "Damn, her ass is fat." And then me, I'd be like, I don't even look. I'd be like, I don't see no other girl. Really?
But you know what, though, and this is just in my experience, I actually feel like. If I dated 10 women, 7 would.
I do think the percentages are higher. I don't know about seven. Seven's high.
Seven would.
But I do think it's more like
so
six.
It's not saying seven all down for three. I'm saying seven. First of all, I do think women check out other women more commonly than we think. There are a couple women I have experienced that's like Caitlin that's like almost repulsed by or doesn't look at other women. But I would say 7 out of 10 either would do it for their man, check out other women, or like
they have the curiosity.
Said, right. Or like yeah, I agree. But it doesn't have to be like
she
a woman.
Did it for me for threesome though?
No, but I think a lot of women would though. But you gotta remember it depends if they've done it before. That. No. So you gotta think about it. Some women will do it for you if they've never done it before. Oh, and women and what's crazy is a lot of women have it on their bucket list.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. A lot of women have that curiosity just to see for the one time.
Yeah.
One time for the one time.
So when like with your girlfriend, right, if she's not into women, at that point it's like how do you I guess what I'm trying to say is, if she's not into women, right, and you want to have a poly,
two dudes,
you got to make sure you are
certain.
Yo, Lydia is wild. Did you
hear that?
Nothing. We're going to scratch her from the rest.
You said it got to be two dudes. You see how offended
you were? Oh, that's gross.
I wouldn't even want that, though.
That's gross.
I'll be honest with you, because there's right. too much going on.
Too many dicks.
What the hell?
But yeah, but I feel like if it was a woman who...
Yo, mama just turned in. Lord.
They go in. I guess, okay, let me tell y'all a story, right? Because I'm trying to get my point out without saying what I'm trying to say, but I'm going to say it anyway. So I know a girl, I ain't going to say no names, but she wasn't into women, right? Mm-hmm. But the guy wanted her to have a girlfriend. So, make a long story short, she told the guy, okay, cool, you can have a girlfriend, it's this and that, whatever. And they went and they found the unicorn, let's just say.
Sure.
So, the unicorn comes into the picture, and the girl is like, oh, well, you know, I'm not really into women like that, but he want me to have a threesome, da 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 da. So, the unicorn go, okay, cool, whatever. The whole time, the girl's just acting weird, she feels uncomfortable, right? Mm-hmm. And so, when they all three get together and they're having a conversation, the girl's just like, well... I feel like I was forced into this because you never knew I was never into women from the beginning. Mm-hmm. So the best thing for her when it came to her poly is like, all right, this girl, the unicorn has her own house, her own world. You go over there and sleep with the unicorn. I have my own house, my own world, and you come sleep with me. We know about each other.
Wives.
Yeah, but that's how some people would prefer a poly because there's a lot of women that are not into women.
Right.
So if you even introduce that, you know, say that to her, you got to respect the fact that she's not into girls. So if she's not into girls, then you get to have two different worlds. Everybody knew about each other. Cool, rock out with your cock out. But if she into girls, then y'all, you slowly ease her into that. And you had those conversations at the bar or in the strip club or whatever.
Mm-hmm. But I do agree with Kadeem. Is like if a girl's not into other women or that's not something they would even desire, the threesome is going to be whack. So it's really no point. It's no point to even bring it up. Then you're just going to have to put all bets on that she's swinging from chandeliers. She's got to own the entire sexual experience because you now have to close off the threesome layer and that's she's got to
you got to shut down one of your fantasies she's gotta, so you better make up for it.
Agreed.
I feel you.
Lydia, my nigga, when we do our own pod, my nigga.
Come on!
Lydia Williams, though.
Right. Please, yo.
But women also...
Lydia's got a studio and everything. Y'all
can
do it.
Women also need to learn to do things that you're into and what makes you happy. Don't agree to it to make him happy because then all you're going to be doing is monitoring him cheating in your brain.
Right.
It's not really going to be a threesome. You're just going to be like...
And that seems
the whole time. And that's weird.
So it's just better to just like you said to and I will say this though, and that's crazy. I know people think I'm completely on the other side of this, but I actually don't mind dating someone who doesn't want to have a threesome. It just means that the actual sex that we're having's got to be bomb.
Be fire.
It's got to be fire. You got to be, you know, car head, all that kind of shit. It's got to be on site.
Willie said, whenever my dick is hard, you better serve it, bitch.
No, but Lydia's right, though. Our experience better be fucking amazing. To where I don't even have to think about it.
You don't think about it.
I won't even.
You're not even worried about that. You're like, all my needs are met.
Like Kadeem said, like the girl walks by the gym, we both don't acknowledge her.
We don't even.
Right.
I ain't gonna lie to y'all. One day we were doing something. We were working out together. And she was like, don't you ever break your neck to look at no girl. And I was like, I looked. I said, what girl? I was like, that girl? It's like, Caitlin. If I'm going to break my neck, you should have looked over there and break his neck to look at that.
No, guys.
You see what's in here? I don't look at her.
When guys are with their girlfriend, they already know not to break their neck. We've already done training.
I was so upset
she
said it. I was like, come on, man. I've been doing this for a very long time.
I didn't look at her.
Exactly. She just wanted, I was like, but the girl was staring at us. So I know. I looked bad.
I know.
I ain't look bad.
You know what we didn't touch on, though? There are men that see you checking out another woman and they get so mad. Like, there's men like that. See, y'all date men, right? But, like, I'll look at a booty and I'm like, oh, that bitch bad. And the dude I'm with, like, you checking her out, you and then like
that's
you mess with a woman
that's
she
super corny.
Because they feel like I love you. I want you all to myself. And we ain't gonna act like it ain't people like that. I want toxic you all to myself. I don't want nobody sleeping with you, dealing with you, period, you even if it's toxic, a woman.
But a lot of women like that trait.
I don't like that shit.
I'm not, that's not
even. Nah, okay, but you gotta remember though, if you bring that toxic, if you bring that energy to a woman, then she's gonna almost like naturally reciprocate that. Now y'all have a level of toxicity where y'all doing it to each other.
I don't think it's toxic. I think it's toxic when men come out and say, well, if you sleep with another woman, it's not considered cheating. No, nigga, it's cheating. Like, that's what it
unless,
is.
Unless we go back to what we
said. Yeah, unless we talk about. But
and that's what I said was cool with me. Yeah.
So you gotta be careful with that, because when somebody says, I want you all to myself, that don't mean I don't got eyes.
Like, right. Mm-hmm. Agreed.
Like, I still got eyes. Agreed. I can still see that ass is fat. I can still see so-and-so in the gray sweatpants swinging. You know what I'm saying? Like, I still have eyes. So you got me. I'm not going nowhere. I'm not going to go, you know, engage with that person. But I see that dick swinging. You know what I'm saying? I see it. He looking good. He buttered up. He got shea butter on. He smelled good.
But when I date somebody, I tell them everything. So it's like, if I'm looking at something, I'm going to be like, you see that?
Yeah, I mean, like, that's how I am. No, but Linda brings up a really good point, because the same women that will go at you for breaking a neck, they'll never acknowledge that they see other guys.
She's seen them gray sweatpants. She saw that nigga swinging, and he might have been swinging more than you. She saw it. She saw it.
Lady, that was a good point.
I do agree with that. They do act like they don't. I know, exactly. No other man exists.
None.
Don't lie to me. Do not lie to me.
None.
I guess we done got all sidetracked. To go back to start video, do you agree with what she said or no?
Yeah, I do. Like, I feel like she's being very honest and the level of honesty that she should be. And I feel like women can't start getting mad when men are doing the same thing. You ask for honesty, there it is.
I think it depends too if you got legs or not. Because I say on my podcast. So basically in Baltimore, when they say you don't got no legs, it means like you can't stand on your own. You not stand on what you say, but you can't like take care of yourself. So if you're in a relationship with a man and he's taking care of everything and you don't really have it right now to leave, let that nigga rock out with his cock out. Let him cheat in peace. Stack your bread and do what you gotta do.
Like, that's the whole plan. Like, that escape
pod. If you gonna leave, then did you mute my mic, nigga?
Like, yeah, where is? I don't have. I need one. One of those bump, bump,
bump. But that's one way to look at it. But then if it's women that also be like, I don't care because he's taking care of everything and I'm happy, like what she was saying, then I don't want to know if you cheat on me.
This is how I look at it, right? If you're with a guy, you're just a few paychecks away from escaping, then that nigga's not really like providing at that level. You should leave him from the jump. A nigga that's really providing on the level is providing at a level that even if you're standing on your own, he's superseding what you're gonna do on your own. So it's not gonna be, yo, I'm four paychecks away from leaving this nigga. No.
You're counting down the
line. I know. What the fuck? Then that nigga's not really holding no shit down.
I guess I was.
Okay, but you still need money before you leave.
Yeah, but that's what I'm saying. Those niggas.
So you still gonna be four paychecks away.
Those niggas deserve to be left already.
Right, but I gotta get my funds together.
We talked about a certain type of man that's we're saying that you're not even 10 years away from being able to be able to remove yourself from him. A guy that's really providing,
it would be a reset.
Yeah, it would be a complete reset. We're talking about the guys
that are.
That's what we're talking about.
No, when we talk
those
about,
are the dudes that he's talking about in the song.
In the video, what I'm saying is most guys do not fall in this category. So I want to be clear. Most guys do not. The average guy is the guy you should leave if he cheats on you. Mm-hmm. What she's saying in the video is if this guy is literally, she said, a leader providing, you know, handling resources. Like, you're talking about a guy who's a rare in some cases. And when I say rare, I'm saying, hey, out of 10 men, we're going to probably find this guy one time.
Yeah.
That's the guy that you're probably saying, hey, I'm not saying condone cheating. I'm just saying if he does cheat, you probably should be more thoughtful about your exit strategy. Yeah. That's all I'm saying.
Should I also, leave? You gotta, what's going to be like if I leave?
Right. And this is what I will say, and most women won't agree, but most long-term relationships, let's call it 10-plus years, all have moments within that relationship that if they got very honest that we could circle and they could have said, hey, at this moment, I could have left him or I could have stayed, and they decided, they did their own way out. It could have been kids, it could have been resources, it could have been timing, and they decided, hey, I'm going to stick it out.
I say that all the time.
Let's take it away, because right now I feel like we put too much emphasis on the money part, right? Like, you could be with somebody and they take care of you and they got everything, da-da-da-da, like what you're saying, right? But if I'm not happy,
If she's not happy and you get on her nerves and you make her sick and you're disrespectful, she's going to stack up her bread and try to figure out what she got to do to get out of that. Mm-hmm. So only way I'm staying with a person that provides for me is I'm also happy.
Agreed.
And I get whatever I want. So I'm just saying that so that women are not listening to this and just saying, well, he's taking care of me, so I stay. No, he's taking care of you and you're happy.
Yeah, absolutely.
If you're happy, then okay. Act like you don't see it,
but
my nigga.
This is what I would say, though. Like, again, if you're with a guy and he's not making you happy, and then you can't get away from that because you're that dependent on him, then that's a bad situation to be in. You should never stay in any relationship you're not happy. So you're telling me that a woman allowed herself to get so down bad that she has to be abused and not happy just to be able to have a roof over her head?
Willie, now, that's on the that other
side.
The
no, but what I'm saying, like,
no, I agree, but I'm saying that's on the other side of this conversation. Now, that's all about, like, your own self-worth and value and what you're bringing to the table. You should never be, like, to me, it's, I guess it's assumed for me that if you're not happy, you're not going to stay.
That's because we wouldn't stay if we weren't happy.
Yeah,
we
I would.
That was all right, I'm out. I'm going.
Mm-hmm. Women would date anything just to say they got somebody, okay? Some women. But yeah.
What about, what would they do on the one night?
I didn't hear nothing you just said.
I said, what would they do on the one night? What is the requirements for a woman to give it up on the first night?
A one night stand?
Yeah.
What's the requirements for you I've to never give it up, or what's the I've requirements
you to give me that thing?
You, yeah, you. What are the requirements? Lydia, what are the requirements?
Well, listen to the question I'm asking
you. Well, let's start. Can I ask first?
We're talking about for me, or like my man is saying he want to have a one-off with someone.
Wait, no. Let's frame this completely different.
Okay.
What would a guy have to do on a date with either one of y'all first time to be able to have a one-night stand? To say that you meet him and the experience was so dope, you decide to take him back.
Yes.
And give
what
him
are those requirements?
Listen.
You want to go first?
I'm gonna Lydia's tap like,
you.
Well, I
I'll
liked
tap
him.
You in. Go ahead,
he
girl.
Liked me.
Tap
we
I'm
fuck.
Tapping you in there. You in there.
Honestly, okay, the type of woman.
Wait, can I ask a question? Because I had this discussion before.
Which question do you want me to answer, Willie?
Wait, I'm about to, I want to clarify something. Are we defining a one-night stand being that is the first time we ever communicated that night, or the first time we ever hung out?
No, the first time I ever met you.
And we smashed.
All right, so if I've talked to you for a couple weeks, and then the first time we actually hang out, I take you down, that don't count?
No, it's not a one-night stand.
Okay, it's not if he beats and he leaves and he never talks to you again?
I'm just wondering.
Ghost. That ain't a one-night
stand. So
I don't know, I never had a
one-night stand.
Wait. Like, wait, that's why I just want to know. So when we're doing, like, I'm doing my own obituary.
If we hung out,
points.
we hung out in person a couple of times, and then we smashed, and then we never.
No,
again. That's not.
No, I'm
a
saying,
one-night
I'm
thing.
Saying, I'm saying. Let's say I met you virtually. Like, hey, we
just
slid in your
just
DM.
Sexing, like you
were
on
sexing.
Tinder for
right,
a couple.
No, right, and so it's a couple weeks, and we finally say, in Kadeem's world, let's go to Ruth Chris.
Okay.
Stop. And then, just your world. And then we go to Ruth Chris, and the vibes are great because we're at the bar, and they know your name.
They do know.
All right, and then I get the Wagyu filet.
Sure.
Yeah. And the vibes are great, and then we decide to go straight to the Westin.
Okay.
And I take you down. Is that
not the Westin?
So that's a one night stand.
I count that.
That's not a one night stand.
So you're not counting that?
No, because I know I was texting them. So at some point, I already knew I was gonna do it. Like,
that's,
you know what I'm saying?
That, there we go.
But a one night stand is like
unexpected.
No, a one night stand is like I went to the club and I met Day Day. And my first
Day-Day
time knowing
Day-Day. Club. Yeah,
and now I'm about to, you feel me? I don't know her from a can of paint.
You
I don't know how many kids he got.
I've
nothing
never
about
done
him.
That. And all the things
you
that I've done. I've done
stand?
Plenty of things.
I've never had a one night stand.
Yo, I mean, I've... No, I mean, not the
I don't
very
go to
first
like
day.
Damn, now I look like
no, that's no, Hoshan.
I've met you girls and hung out one time and cracked and
I knew that.
Yeah, but I've never went out, met to somebody at the club. I don't want to, I just met you, but I don't know you.
So you ain't never been on vacation?
No.
All right, I'm going to shut up.
All right, anyway, the criteria, right?
No, she better.
The criteria.
You ain't never been on
the requirements?
Yes.
Honestly, the way I'm defining it, even if we spoke before via text, but we've never hung out in person, even if we spoke before, that's still a one-night stand. And yes, I've done it. And the requirements are I just have to be horny and single. Mm. Mm-hmm. Like,
okay.
So his looks don't matter? Does, like, what he got going on?
If I met you in person to have this encounter, you already had to be fine.
True. I agree with
you. To me. You asked about me.
Yeah.
Lydia,
to me,
Lydia
I got to be horny. You got to be fine. You haven't repulsed me yet. Okay. As long as you haven't repulsed me, if I'm getting swirly, We can get a pop.
God, the bar is so low.
Oh, God. Listen, if I'm in the mood to have a one-night stand, like, I do what I want. My body.
But I feel like a lot of women do, and I feel like that... I actually think Lydia's example, most women have done. They just won't admit it.
Yeah, you met him on Tinder.
That is very common. Like, especially if we talk, we communicate. Like, there's times where I might hang out, like, talk to someone for weeks before we ever hang out. Mm-hmm. So I've built up enough equity by the time we hung out, I'm taking you down. Right. Period.
But I don't consider it a one-night stand. And you usually would talk to her again.
Right. That's why I kind of agree with Vicky. It's kind of like 50-50. Because what Lydia is saying in her example, you wouldn't have gotten that much conversation and time for me to even, to build that up. Mm-hmm. So I agree with Vicky. The hardest thing to do, Ms. Brown, I'm sorry. The hardest thing to do.
I might have called you Vicky.
The hardest thing to do is to do the get it off the very first time in the club to see you and take her down in the same night. That is, if I was ranking guys like success rate, I would give him a double pound for doing it. Like,
that
first meet.
Only thing,
that's pretty successful.
Yeah, I've never done that.
Yeah. That's like, I'm putting that on your banner in the Raptors. Yeah.
If a woman meets you in a club and y'all have sex afterwards, it ain't you took her down, nigga. I chose you.
Right.
Like, what you talking about? Like,
they always think they chose us.
To be honest with you. But in my world.
Because women control access to sex, as y'all say.
Exactly. Okay. So in my world, requirement for one night stand would have to be, I'm out of town. I ain't gonna never see this nigga again. I was being honest. Like, I gotta be somewhere at the vibe nights. I ain't gonna never see you again. You gotta look good. Cause I date ugly niggas. So if I date you, it's okay if you ugly and other things fall out there. So yeah, you gotta look good. You gotta be some type of, like, you know, social status type thing. And that's how that
works. All right, but I wanna talk because you said something that Lydia said women control access to sex. That's why it's a bigger point for a man, because a woman controls it, and then I'm able to get that from you. Because
it's a bigger point for you, but still, I chose it.
So if you can't get your pussy back and I get that from you, I'm taking the point for the night.
You get the point.
But I think reason why I'm saying it's not you choosing, it's me, because when I like someone, I'm not going to sleep with them right away. If I sleep with you right away, that means I don't care if you think I'm a hoe. I don't like you. I don't see a
And I'm aligned
with
that thought process. So you wait. I don't care what you think. I don't care what I think. We're going to fuck the first night and we never talk again. I still think the point's for the man.
The point is for the man.
The point's for the man.
I don't even know how y'all don't think that.
Listen, we don't care about the point.
But we're saying...
Y'all are talking about points right now.
No, y'all said, I choose.
I choose you, not I get the point.
But dudes in here. You pick any of them.
But you don't realize.
I choose you. I choose you is not the same as I'm taking a point. It's literally... We spoke, and I decided to open my legs for you.
Okay, so I got a question.
Like, I don't have to do that.
I got a question from a societal perspective. Obviously, everybody gets to live their own lives. Is it when a man talks about, hey, I fucked 200 women, and a woman says, I fucked 200 men, which one has a more polarizing to the negative? The man, when the man says it, or the woman says it?
The woman says it. So I guess what you're getting at is...
negative. The woman. Oh, the negative. The woman says she fucked 200 people, you're going to be like, what?
Because women control access to sex. Yeah, so we're saying... So what we're saying is, if a woman came in here and said, yo, last night I went to the club, and I got a guy to buy me a fucking Cartier bracelet on his phone, and I walked away, we'd be like, oh,
wow,
shit.
Wow, magic.
Yes. We would dap you up the same way if the guy walks in and said, hey...
Then I get the point.
Yeah, you definitely.
You get the point. You get 6,700.
Well, I don't give a fuck about points. Yes.
But what I'm saying is, I'm not going off of points. I'm going off of I chose you. I don't want you to think you chose me. I mean, it's cool. You could think highly of yourself because you had to have something for me to want to do that on the first night. If that's what you're getting at. But I'm saying is, I chose you. You didn't come to me. I already knew when I met you that night that this is what I was going to do.
Yep.
And that's what it was.
And a great rapper once said, "Once I hit you once, you are always a part of my collection."
I'm not even gonna remember that nigga.
You don't
I
have
ain't
to.
Gonna hold you.
You're a part of my collection.
I feel
but
the
just
same.
Know, just know, when if we ever cross paths or I ever see you on Instagram, you're a part of my collection.
That's fine.
Fair enough.
We
agree. Okay.
Women understand that.
No, we're aligned.
We understand.
That's the best thing to be.
Yeah.
You forget me, I forget you, but you're a part of my collection.
Honestly, I
think that's the best thing.
If I had a one night stand, when I do see that dude,
And I want to be clear. I'm the type of nigga that don't want you to speak. I don't want us to ever cross paths again, and you still will be a part of my collection. That's actually a win for me.
Yes. Okay, Willie, have your points.
No, I'm just saying that.
Keep your points.
What I'm saying is, for most men, right? So most men, and somebody has said this before on their platform, it is a race versus resources given out until I sex versus how much sex and how much less resources I have to allocate. You just gave me an example where no resources had to be exchanged. And I got what I wanted. I'm going to take that as a W in every case.
Okay, Willie, we're not on the field.
First of all, we are.
We're not on the field.
Excuse me, what you're not understanding is we're not saying it's not a point. What I'm getting at is don't think that you chose
me. It doesn't matter what you think. That's what he's saying.
That's it. That's all I'm saying.
It don't matter.
It's a win for you. Cool. No, but don't think you came at me. I came at you.
But how, when women control access to it.
So listen.
So the message is that night you've already unloosened the key for me and the access is free.
The door is cracked. I just decided who I let in.
Fair enough.
No, honestly, it could have been anybody.
Brain is not understanding what I'm saying. I'm not saying that it's not a win for you. What I'm getting at is like before we was on this platform.
More semantics, bro.
I'm saying before on this platform. Oh, whatever. Whenever we was on this platform last time, we talked about the whole thing with PNB Rock, remember? Mm-hmm, and you was like, and I was like, oh, because I bagged him. And you was like, women be thinking that they picked the dude and they bagged the dude. That's not how it go. In this situation, nigga, I bagged you. That's how I feel.
So you walked up, you went in the club, you said, hey, you, come here.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. If I'm on demon time, it's, yo, you look good, nigga. What you doing later?
Right. And sometimes women will say that we bagged you because we did it covertly. Y'all not even smart enough to know that I picked you sometimes. Okay. Sometimes I did it with my eyes and said, come here, nigga.
I was like,
and you came.
Women just think
and they came.
They do. Yeah. So I'm like, okay.
You saw me looking at you and I said, get over here,
they don't
boy.
Think picking
I said, come here, bring that dick here. Bring that dick here.
We don't know if they put themselves in our proximity. We don't know any of that.
It's a win for you. That's cool.
Yo, I promise you more.
Yeah, let me give you this W.
More women that have those type of night and one night stands came in and was like, man, I didn't even think I was going to let them fuck. You hear that way more than I bagged you. But again, we're going to stay congruent through this whole thing because I don't understand. That means you were on your mask. Masculine trait that day, and you
I
went
was.
Out.
Yes.
Yes. Yeah, I got
I was.
It. I got
That's
it.
Exactly
so,
right.
How often are you in your masculine again?
That was, first of all, that was just that I was on vacation.
No, okay. So it's okay to be in your masculine when you're on vacation in Club Live.
Go get
Miami.
That dick.
Yes, go
first
get that
of
dick.
All, first of all.
No, we know you like Miami.
No,
don't do it.
I do like Miami. I do like Miami, but that's why I said, what's the requirements for one night stand and what's the requirements for you being in a relationship? If I really like this guy and I know that he's something, like he's a good catch, I'm going to move completely different.
If I'm just having my fun, I'm just having my fun. We have to talk about this because, Willie, we always go into this have a women be like you choosy with the guy you choosy with the guy that you want to be with but you fuck this random dude the first day
because
and then you want the guy that you want to want you but he like I mean obviously you're not gonna tell him like yo I met what you call him Ray Ray Taquan whatever the fuck
it doesn't matter
was. Yeah one of those names you met him in the club you Jody. Fucked him but then you want me to like bend over backwards and do backflips.
Because that's why I said, don't tell your man your past. How he going to know that I was out here dying in Miami? He's never going to know. I'm never going to tell him how he's going to know. Lord. I'm in a whole different state. I could be Aisha in Miami. Who cares?
I do agree with that. I still always going to disagree with
that
idea.
We're not going to act like women don't. We do the same thing that y'all do to a certain extent. That's just like when they be so strong on femininity. Like, everybody has an equal balance in them. You got a masculine side, you got a feminine side. At some point, I'm gonna wanna rock out with my cock out. At some point, I'm doing me.
So I got a question. So you're telling me that this has been a lie that women have said for years, that when they go out and they do have a one night stand, it's like, man, I didn't even think I was gonna fuck them. They've been lying the whole time.
A lot of the times, yes, they are.
They already knew.
Sometimes they'll be like me, like, no, I already knew I was gonna take some dick home. I was just shopping around.
I really don't.
Like, I knew I done been in the locker room talk with the girls too and then be like, oh, let's go out get some dudes for tonight. Like, we're fishing. Okay?
You put yourself
but a lot of the times women will lie about that. They'll come, oh, I never done this before.
I think that they lie about it because they enjoy the vibe and then once it happened, they probably sit back and be like, oh damn, this could have been something. But and they care about how people gonna view them at the end of the day. Two, when I did do things like this, I never told anybody. This is probably my first time coming out on a platform or in general talking about it. But we have our fun. And what is wrong with that?
No, no,
guess
no,
what?
No.
If you get with a woman and she never did these things, she gonna be cheating on you when she seen the cutest
totally
thing or
that.
Whatever.
So I'm trying to disagree with that.
No, no, that part I
agree. Oh, no, no, don't, wait, no, don't I, scare I, me like that. No, 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 I got a good girl. Please Don't tell me it's a lie, bro.
I agree with Ms. Brownstone on all that. I think we're aligned on everything. I'm just saying we're aligned on everything. All I'm saying is the only part that we're probably a disconnect is, and this is just probably how we're going to view things. You're going to view it as you was on demon time. I'm going to view it as I was that nigga, and we're going to both walk away.
We're both that nigga.
You was that nigga. Right. And at that moment, I was that. Yeah, so I'm waiting for the day
that I can do that, and then we both get up, we dap each other up,
and we go.
That's how it's gonna go.
I literally think I've dapped you up. I haven't experienced that.
But I'm looking forward to
but
that.
But I have to circle back. Y'all are telling me.
You kick a nigga out, yo. You gotta go. You have those moments. It is what it is.
Lily, your worth is too high. They want you to stay. That's the problem. You never experienced it because you were. This is the thing, though.
This is the thing, though. The dudes that you having these one-night stands with,
they ain't worth shit.
Yeah, they ain't dudes that you know, like, you could be with long-term and he could take care of you. Man, it's just, right, that, you just look good. That's it. You can't do nothing else for me. I don't care if you think I'm a hoe. I don't care.
I just want to see what I'm having my fun.
Right. And after this, I'm not going to talk to you.
I just want to know, like, how do you attract that? Because now I'm like, okay, so if I'm on that time.
Bro, wait, stand up.
Because I know if
Kenny get his stats up.
Wait, because I'm trying to figure out. So if that's, so then it's
you
me.
Got a lot of these bitches and telling me broke. Okay.
No, I ain't telling
you broke. Don't buy them no drinks.
That's not what she said. No.
I'm confused.
Buy them two drinks max.
No. They got to have stats. Like, all right. Like,
maybe. Talking about for a one night stand. Willie wants to be a one night stand. Like, just fuck him and not care.
Lydia's saying status.
Right. Y'all are not alone.
Lydia's like, he got to be a dusty broke, but he kind of fine. He walked to the club.
I knew I could get him to fine.
And I was swirly.
No.
And I don't give a fuck about you. That's why I don't give a fuck about you.
I have never had a one night stand with a
dusty.
Oh, yeah, no.
Okay.
But if I'm in, since you want to bring up Miami, if I'm in Miami and I see a dude, let's say he been on some type of platform or something like that. Hey, yo, I be seeing you doing like, what's
remember
up
we talking
you?
About blue checks?
Mm-hmm. And that's just,
this is where that blue check
you
come through.
You have like, fun.
Oh, he's got
know.
A blue check? One night stand. We need blue checks. I don't need a blue check.
This is how it works in my mind because I don't want to, I'm never going to be serious with no rapper, no athlete, none of these things because then I got to hear this if I get caught cheating stuff or throw in my face, even though I know it might happen. But I would never be serious with them. So it would be just like, oh, I'm just having my fun and call my girl in the morning like, yo, you know such and such.
See, we're not aligned. Because I would try and keep him, even if I know you're a cheating ass.
Mm. Mm.
No, I'm good. See, I want to marry the nerd. I don't want to have one night stand.
We want to talk about the requirements to get wife, or we want to press on.
No, I like. I want to talk about so the requirements for getting wife. So are we leaving me off of this one night stand conversation, or just in?
Yeah, I mean they were slash, but then we went on a tangent about one night.
So, but I do agree with Ms. Brownstone that 99% of the women that get wifed also had one night stands.
They did.
In situations that we'll never know about.
We'll never know.
Mm-hmm.
So I do agree with her on that. 100%. I'm going to agree, as much as this pains me, because I want to disagree with her. I actually do agree women shouldn't talk about their past to that degree.
They shouldn't. It's not smart.
She's right.
It's not smart.
Because I've actually dated someone that I didn't have the Miss Brownstone type one night stand. I had the Lydia one, but I thought when we did it, I actually thought way less. I know you guys defined it differently. See how women are that not congruent. But anyway, that I thought after that experience, I thought less of the experience. Mm-hmm. I thought we weren't going to talk no more. She ended up being dope and cool, but I thought it was like, yo, wham, bam.
Right.
I ain't gonna lie. I never like smashed a girl once. I got a double back.
Yeah. No, but I thought, I kind of agree with Miss Brownstone. It's like my idea of her, because when she did it, you start thinking, oh, this is how she gives it up.
Exactly.
And so now she's right. Then my idea of her in my head went down because I'm like, oh, this is what she does. Because I always
even after you was talking to her for weeks.
Yeah, because I actually am very, as much as y'all don't agree, think this is the case. I'm very like self aware, so I don't like think I'm just this way rare guy that you're just gonna turn up just this one time. I'm gonna think this is a part of your identity. Mm-hmm. So I agree with Ms. Brownstone. Like, yeah. So when we did it, I'm like, oh, this is what you're used to doing. Mm-hmm. So I'm not gonna put you in a wife category. I'm gonna put you in a we had fun category. She ended up being cool and dope and actually came out of that box. But originally, Ms. Brownstone's right. Like,
originally, but you just said she came out of that
box.
She
did.
She had to earn that though.
But that's what I'm saying. But she's right though. Ms. Brownstone's right. Like, she had to like go above and beyond to even get out of that box.
Even after talking to her for weeks?
Yeah, because I thought that's how she gives it up.
And you know, I don't even be, but I don't be pressed to smash on the first time.
I don't either. That's what I'm saying, because she was, though.
But even the times where it's happened, if I was talking to you for weeks, I'm not going to be like.
No, she was. I thought it was odd, because I was like, I ended the night. I was like, yo, boom. I went to go back to the room.
She pressed up on
She texted me and was like, I'm trying to come back. And I was
It's the same as like when you sleep with a dude, when you go, when you about to have sex with a guy, right, and he don't pull out, he don't have a condom. I'd be like, oh nah, nigga, that mean you raw dogging all these bitches. Or
I agree
or let's say I'm having a one night stand, right. He try to eat me out, right. I'ma think, oh, so you be putting your mouth on anything, nigga. Like, I would never be with you. I would never be nothing with
She's
you
right.
Because I'm always gonna think that's how you move.
So
don't tell them what you did before.
So the strategy, so we talked about getting wives. Ms. Brownstone said one of her criteria is if she does think this is somebody she would want to get wife by, she's less likely to give it up in a short time frame. Is that correct?
Correct. Mm-hmm.
And then as a guy, well, how would you feel about it if you were looking
at just, because we already know that they do the one night stand shit.
Mm-hmm.
So you're not going to just fuck Ray Ray and then you think you're going to put me through the Steve Harvey night.
So, Kadeem is basically saying, like, even if you did give it up to me in a short time period, I am aware that women do that, so it's not necessarily.
I'm gonna feel more like I just want to. Nah, you, because I know you smash Ray Ray, so don't tell me you gonna make me wait. For 80 days.
And I'm not gonna say wait.
I'm of the same.
But you're not gonna say wait though. But I'm not gonna lie. Like, you still want it to have some type of, like, there's some value
special to you, Willie.
I don't want to upset. Don't do me like that. But no, but I do kind of agree. Like, you do want
it to feel special.
No, y'all niggas trying to play.
Like, I'm not talking. Physically, I want it to feel
like. He's like, I just want it to be magic.
No.
Right.
I just want that first time to be special.
It's not that. It's not about feeling special, but I agree with Ms. Brown.
You sound like Lil Willie.
Nah.
Okay.
This is, as much as Ms. Brownstone's right, there's the person that you're probably gonna take serious the first time, it's gonna be a little different. It ain't gonna be, I'm gonna pull up to your apartment, you're gonna come out and I'm gonna smash you in my car.
Right.
Y'all still fucking
But if we follow the same congruency of niggas we really don't care about, we don't care what they think, you don't have that same criteria. So what I'm saying is, if this is somebody I'm really dating, it's probably gonna happen after a dope vibe, conversation. We're gonna like.
But to me, when I'm thinking about it, I'm like, well, we're going to hang out. It's going to be a dope vibe anyway. I'm not pressed to smack on the first try.
Yeah, me neither.
I'm not even really looking to do that. If it happens, it happens. If we was talking for a month, then I ain't going to look at her no type of way.
So does sex have any value or any, like, repercussions on a woman getting wife? Like, how do you view?
I just think if it's a girl that you know, and you know, like, a lot of niggas that know her, then you're going to be like, nah, I'm cool on that.
So listen, and tell me if I'm right, you specifically, I feel like in your mind, if she smashes you in a short amount of time, or you smash her, because I know you don't like the idea of you being smashed, whatever, whatever, I feel like in your mind, you would just think like, oh, of course she would, because I'm that nigga.
Yeah.
Boom.
I don't feel that way.
But no, but I'm still.
Will, I forgot what I was about.
You are that nigga. You are.
I don't like you niggas together.
You are that nigga. No, but Willie, believe in yourself.
What I'm saying is, it's like, if we're vibing like that, then why wouldn't we? I just don't put. It's not that. It's not like a super high, like, oh, she fucked me.
Yeah, like, you busted it down for Ray Ray, so of course you're gonna bust it down for me because I'm better.
I forget. Damn. What I was about to say is,
supposed to butt in and like, I'm A Mike too.
Go ahead.
What I was about to say is, when you were saying about the whole waiting thing, it's not so much like I'm on a calendar crossing off the days, like, got to be 90 days. It's more like I want him to be into me before I do it. That way it does mean something, and then he's already kind of invested. Because this is going to sound messed up, but I say this on my podcast all the time. Like, if a man invests into you financially, emotionally, energy, all the other stuff, then a dude don't want to leave his money behind. You feel me? And at the end of the day, time equals money and vice versa. So if he done invested so much time into me and them pockets, he not about to just let it go like that. You feel me? So that's why I'm like, I'd rather wait and get him all wrapped up in me, and then I'll do that.
I do agree with
that. I respect that.
I agree with that.
I just don't hold it that.
But that's what I'm saying. So we talked about this idea of how to get wifed. So from a man perspective, does sex have anything to do with the trajectory you put a woman on versus a wife trajectory, or just somebody you just chilling with?
Only if it's if it's not fire. If it's fire, then she might be on a good. If we got to that point, that where we doing that on a regular.
So you're saying that sex has nothing to do with what track you get on, but if it's not fire, you could potentially get off a wife track.
Yes,
we're off that track.
Oh, hmm.
You can't be somewhere it's not fire.
Nah.
Fair enough. Because I agree with you. I still believe, and I've heard someone say this, and I actually agree. I think when a man decides to be monogamous and get married, they are saying in one of the bullets, I'm not saying it's the bullet, that this is the top tier. This is the vagina that I'm willing to have by my one and only for the rest of my life.
Yep.
If that's what marriage means to them.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
Unless you're into like poly. Or
can I just say something real quick?
Of course.
You see how y'all put so much weight or emphasis or whatever I'm trying to say on sex. Sex is so important to y'all, and then y'all get mad when women think they the prize. I just want to say that. So y'all get mad when women be like, no, he got to give me this in order to get this. But y'all lead with sex with y'all mind all the time. So don't get mad when some of y'all get finessed.
No, but I agree.
Your energy is worth pussy. That's what you just said.
But I actually agree. Y'all know that. No. Because I'm about to go back to this, because this is why I'm all about congruency. That's why I said, if we know that sex is big on our board and we fuck you without giving no resources,
you're giving it away tonight.
It's a fucking point. Yeah.
Everybody knows.
We did the board before. A man cares about sex. So that is something they're going after. That is because women control access to it, and they control access to reproduction. So we know that sex is high on our board. And honestly, with all due respect, for most women, we don't think sex is as high on the board for women, because women have always had openness or abundance of sex thrown at them. Mm-hmm. But most men look at sex in a scarcity mindset. So of course, sex is high here for a man. I'm not saying women don't care about sex, but it's probably here for a woman.
Willie,
it just is.
Willie, so why do we hear have to you? Go so hard we just not rolling. We hear what you're saying.
I guess what I was getting at is the fact that men are now asking women, what do you bring to the table? And what else do you have to offer besides vagina? And I give vagina anywhere, but y'all put so much emphasis on it. So what do y'all expect? Like, that's just what I'm, that's all I, when I hear y'all, when y'all was having that conversation, that's what, you know.
No, what I was saying, it doesn't sway me if she fucks me in a week or fucks me in 10 days, but you put emphasis on sex
when you sat there and said, if it's not fire, she won't get wifed.
Yeah, we're talking about wife.
Yeah, you don't want to be in a,
we all pick and roll some joints we don't care about. So that ain't that high to me. But if I'm going to, if she's my girl, that shit's fire.
Yes.
But what if she has everything else, but her sex isn't all that?
Then she's your friend. Then that's your best friend.
Yeah, she's
cool. But then that's when you're putting emphasis on sex.
Can I be honest with you?
In general.
Money's not the criteria, but if he broke, you want to be with him?
No, all right, exactly.
Argument over. Get out of here.
But I think we all agree, and I think as society, this goes for man and woman, that we should never downplay intimacy and sex and it being something that we are attracted to. And I think what Ms. Brownstone said is kind of not fair to any person. If I don't care if they have everything, if this person cannot sexually please you or you're not happy with the physical part of the relationship, that should be something we should lay out as a desire for us. Yes. We deserve to have great sex, especially if we're going to be monogamous.
Both ways.
Why you can't just teach her? If she got everything else and y'all care so much.
But she might not have to say that. He didn't say that. Hey, I didn't try. I asked him a very direct question. I said, hey, how does sex play a role in the trajectory of wifing? He actually downplayed sex and said, hey, the only thing that can hurt me not wifing her is if the sex is whack.
Right.
And that's actually what you guys would want. You would not want a guy. Trust me, no one would want to be with a guy.
You wouldn't tie yourself in a marriage, because we're using the word wife. You would not tie yourself for the rest of your life to have sex with someone that is not pleasing you.
I'm not saying that it's the only. I do think a woman, your intimacy level or your connection with that woman physically can have a direct correlation in the success of a monogamous relationship.
Facts.
Yeah.
I think that's just how men think, because there's women that would be in a long-term relationship with a man who is not satisfied.
But that's why Willie totally said it's higher on our board than y'all.
Everything else, he's probably paying more bills.
I'd be congruent like a motherfucker.
I know. I don't know why they're not listening.
No, I hear what you're saying. I guess the point in my mind, as I was thinking about it, I was just saying that I think it's crazy how men always get mad that women think they're a prize and women think they should be chased. But when you put so much emphasis on sex that when it comes to who you will wife, you're telling me if it's whack, I won't wife her. But if she has all the other things and characteristics and things you need in a wife, why she can't get wifed?
Like, I don't get it. Kadeem gave you the perfect example. Sex, I think we all agree, even when I've heard you speak before, sex is analogous to resources from a man. So it's the same thing. If a woman tells me, and I've had this experience, yo, I make X amount of dollars a year, I swear to God, it never has moved me one bit.
It won't. Why would it?
I've walked away from women that have money. I don't care about that.
Y'all want that. Y'all say it don't matter, but then you don't want to know Dusty. No, we know that.
Go ahead. I'm saying I'm on the extreme level of, like, if a woman treats me right, has great sex, and, like, truly gives me the energy that I think I deserve, I don't give a fuck where you work at.
Facts. You don't got to work
I don't
at
care.
All. If I really don't, fuck with you.
Yeah, the girl at Burger King, I would pull up, like, whatever. And she's really, really treating me right.
It's not anything. He said he just named a number of things and that the sex was fine.
Right. But I'm saying,
because she don't got to. He's already deep in the six figures. She don't got to do that.
Yeah, but what I've learned though, just in relationships, is for me, my number one is how someone treats me. Facts. I care more about that than resources.
Yep.
That's not something I value.
Facts.
Yeah, that should be.
But I also respect Miss Brownson when she came in last time. If I met a woman, she said number one for me is resources and a guy, my security, someone to take care of me, I promise you, I would be like, I respect that. You should. Right. And I think as women get older, if you want my honest opinion, a woman should actually value resources even more, as if they have kids, if they're older, if they're like in their 30s, whatever their case is. I think a young woman should probably value resources like 5. I think as you get older, you should start putting that up to your 1.
And we do, but that's as you should. People like Kevin would be like, buy a dog and die alone because you're old and you have kids. So you see how it's opposite? Like, those are the times where you should care about resources way more as a woman.
But that's why we do.
However, that's not what y'all are looking for. And so it's flip-flopped. It's opposite. It's wrong.
I think we should program women at a young age to care about that, because at that time when you're in your prime and you looking good, you should be able to get that older guy that's
But when you're settled. In your prime... You fucking Ray at the club on the way.
In Miami.
God damn it.
We're not going to tell him.
That's what you're doing. When you're in your prime, you're like, oh, he look good. He got a blue check. I'm a fucker.
Wait a minute. Damn. Let me explain something. I'm in my prime. I just turned 26.
Talk your shit.
Now, let's be honest. I done had my share, whatever, da 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 da, but... I know when something is good and I want to be with it. You get what I'm saying? But there's people out here that's not telling women at a young age, like, listen, at some point you have to get married and have kids, and you should be with a man that can take care of you. That's the point I'm making. Let it be known. But get it off you, though. I really do think you should.
But what happens is society...
Between 18 to, like, 23... Rock out with your cock out.
I agree with that.
Be a big
for
one.
Sure. No, I actually agree with you. I'm gonna agree with her in this regard. I think women overextend that time frame. She's right. 18 to 23, you can almost. I know y'all. I'm gonna get no love from men. You can somewhat bypass or hide your hoe phase and move on. I do agree with that.
Possibly.
And then what I'm saying is, though, some women, number one, they get pregnant in their hoe phase.
Or they
get attached to doing something they can't remove. But by the time you're 26, 27, she's right. You're still in your prime, and you should turn your face towards marriage. But what happens is some women get so happy in the club and so
they think they can do it till they're 35. Yeah. Thank you. Yes.
And then by 35, we're like, damn.
Nobody wants
8 years ago, I would have.
Yeah. No. Listen.
You're right.
When you're at the top is when you retire. Okay? You're at the top.
Nobody teaches women that.
Whole season. And you're, not your whole season. You're at the top of your, like, beauty, your prime, whatever the fuck. That's when you make your exit and go find
women. No, but see, this is what happens, though. When women are at the top, they actually dog the niggas that they...
The good guy.
Of course.
We're trying to correct that. No. But this is what Kevin was saying. These women in their prime, they'll be like 7s. And then they'll dog niggas who are like 8s and, like, really stable.
Facts.
And because they used to fuck... Or have had experiences with niggas who are probably 9s and 10s.
Oh my God!
So when they're at their prime, they don't have the self awareness to really realize that they should be actually aligned with a 7 or 8.
Yes.
And then by the time they realize that they should be aligned with a 7 or 8, that nigga has now came into his full potential.
Yes.
And he's like, nah,
because they think that they fucked that dude in the club that was a 10.
Yes.
Because she was opening the legs for him.
Because she was
and
in
she
Miami,
thinks I can get 10. And then she goes home where she's really a 6, and she can't fuck with the 8s. And then when she's 30, we don't want you no more.
We don't want you no more.
God damn it, Willie.
Preach.
I'm Jesus not saying you're
Christ.
Wrong. I'm Preach. Not. I didn't
That's
hear
exactly
any lies.
What happens.
So, I agree with you.
Because when you're 23, you can go get any 10.
Keep teaching these women to have self-awareness.
Yes.
Chris Brownstone's doing the good Lord's work.
Check their looks. Mm-hmm. Check where they're at in their life. And give them honest assessment. Mm-hmm. Like my nigga did, RIP Kevin.
RIP
Kevin. Tell these women what men they really deserve.
Facts.
Yes.
If you're a 7, you deserve a 6.
Look at us all in agreement. Wait.
Yes.
I don't know Miss Brownstone not in agreement.
What?
She's like, what?
What? No. If you're a 7, you deserve a 6.
No, but Willie is...
Because you
guys can be young and fine.
No, I agree with all that.
Yeah, and go fuck dudes that really are kind of out of your realm, but he just want to fuck anyway.
But I feel like out of your realm, what, in looks?
No, just in life. If he's, if you're 23 and you're going to fuck with a 32-year-old,
which happens really all the time.
Yeah, he don't really want nothing to do with you.
Right.
Right. Mm-hmm. But you like, oh, he lit. He got this. He got that. He might even chill.
And then,
you
and then I'll be 25 and I'd be like, hey, Miss Brownson, but yep. Like, mm-hmm. Nigga, no.
Yep. Yep.
You got a fucking broke down Honda and this nigga pulling me up in the fucking
yep,
Porsche.
Yep. Yep. But
I'd be like, but look, I'm getting my MBA. I'm in law school. So like, nigga,
so what you saying is, women at a young age, when they meet a guy that got like, they see the potential in him, he's doing what he got to be doing. You should be dealing with that guy instead of going after the older dude.
No, I'm saying that they don't have the awareness to really say, okay, if I do plan on getting married, I'm not even saying beautiful.
To realize that right, higher level guy doesn't actually want you because you're so young and in your whole season.
Right, 1,000%. Okay. And what I'm saying is, this is what I would give feedback to men, just like you're coaching women. I think a man, when he's 23, 24, don't even open yourself up to a Miss Brownstone to let her shoot you in the head.
Facts.
You go focus on your life. You go chase the money. Go chase the success because women come with that shit. Period.
I just want to say I've been telling niggas that all the time.
All day long.
And let me say to those girls though, because I have known many of them, the ones that fuck the higher level dudes or whatever, and really try and like get them, like you do have to be aware that he's at this point in his life and you're so young and you're actively out here hoeing and glowing.
Hoeing,
you should know.
There's no.
You should know that he's not going to take you seriously. No, so when you're acting, when you're talking to me and saying, "Oh, Liddy, he didn't text me back," or he acting funny, or he's being distant because he actually doesn't want you. He's 30, whatever, and he's got his whole life together, and you're out here in the club getting drunk and fucking Ray Ray on the weekend, like
hoeing and glowing.
He's not going to take you serious. You're not even taking yourself serious. But you're in your hoe season, so don't worry about it. Keep going. Keep going. Hoeing and glowing. And then when you turn, whatever the fuck, when the hoe season should be ending, but you're still fine, and then you pivot and find you the man to stay with. Because they'll take you a little bit more seriously because you're a little bit older. And by this time, you have a wealth of sexual experience.
She's right. I agree.
Well, we unpacked that. You're not aligned with us, though.
Hmm? Are you aligned with us?
No.
Are you aligned with me? Because I don't feel like
I'm not saying I'm not in line with anything. I understand where you're getting at. I guess I'm when people say things to me, I'm trying to picture me at that age. And at that age, when I was like 18 and all that stuff, I worked at a Caribbean nightclub, right? Mm-hmm. And I had doctors that came into the nightclub that was trying to get at me. So I'm trying to understand what you're saying. Is like when I met them doctors that was trying to get at me, I never wanted to talk to them because I knew that I would just be fun to them.
Yeah.
So I'm understanding
most
what you're saying.
Most girls don't know that they're a fun girl.
So I'm understanding what you're saying. Then I'm also thinking about it like, all right, Vic, when you was in high school, was you even paying attention to the nerds and the dudes that got like,
no,
you feel
no.
me?
Yeah, I don't know. Yeah.
No, because I wanted to talk to the guys that was in college that was already, you know, I feel like that was them already showing me what they got going on. So
do women that the dudes that's in college that go back to high school to get girls, they don't get girls.
They're corny, but we don't know that.
But you know what though? We know what she's describing, which is so like I've diagnosed this in my own head. Forever, that was the school version of hypergamy.
Yep. Yeah.
So that's why I'm saying, that's why I'm like trying to comprehend what y'all saying, because I'm like, do this in line with what I'm teaching women? Because what I'm telling women is, at your young age, you should get a man that is older than you, that already got, that's showing you see the grapes and the apples falling. You feel me? Mm-hmm. I'm not going to go after the older guy with a house and married with kids, because of course he don't want me. But I would say if you in high school, get with the dude that's in college to be in law school or whatever, and you see he got something going on. You know what I mean? And you get around them type of people and you elevate. That's how I would look at it.
I would never tell
the girl in high school to go after the dude in college, only because they're hoeing.
Them niggas are hoeing. I look at it completely different. I think a woman in her 18, 19, 20, number one, they should think with the end in mind that say, hey, at some point, do you want to get married? At some point, do you want to have kids with this person? Whatever that person is, make sure that during this hoe phase or this time that you're going to college or you're figuring out your career, just don't do anything that could irreversible to stop that. But do I think a woman at 18, 19 should even be thinking about a relationship? My personal opinion, no. There's no value in it.
But you also got to understand that women think about their wedding day and all that stuff before
y'all.
But I guess what I'm saying is,
true.
No matter what, we're going to think about relationships. No. And when I was, let me speak, please. When I was in my teens, I wasn't really worried about a dude, but the dude that I was dealing with, he was already in college. He had his own stuff going on. So I felt like at that point, I'm around I'll get around him. I'll meet his friends. They're older than me. They can pour into me. They can show me things. That's how I was looking at it. I wasn't looking at the men that was my age, that was a nerd, that could have something going on, because I don't see the fruits of your labor.
So first and foremost, thinking about something is a dime a dozen. Everybody can think about something. At 18 years old, thinking about a marriage is not actually going to say that's going to happen anytime soon. At the end of the day, we're saying is that if you're thinking about getting married, you're going to say, hey, I'm going to get married at some point. What can I do now? What work can I put in now to be ready to even attract somebody I would want to marry? Those guys you would mess around at 18 or 19 years old, every woman I've ever talked to are just guys that now are just guys in your past that you fucked. Mm-hmm. They're just somebody who's looks at you and says, yeah, I remember a time when I was with so-and-so and I used to have her pissy popping on a handstand. So at 18, 19 years old, very rarely have I met someone that's like, yo, I met the guy of my fucking dreams. We got married and we've been together for 12 years. That is rare. That's less sub 1%. So at 18, 19 years old, to even say, guess we're going to think about it, and these are the guys I was attracting, where are they at now? Yeah. Nowhere. Yeah. So at 18, 19 years old, you should be about your motherfucking self. Think about, hey, at some point, I do want to get married, and how do I want to show up in the world when I do find that guy at 26, 27? What do I want to have on my person? Yeah. Here's the problem. Here's the problem with minority women. Most women get pregnant between the ages of 18 and 28. So now you're carrying somebody from a guy that literally is not in your life.
Yeah. Valid.
The idea that, I'm going to teach girls when they're 18, 19 to go look for a dude. Go look for a dude for what? To help you while you're getting your tuition done at fucking Howard? That's what you should ask for a guy.
A guy
to come pick you up and take you from one class to the other, because you need to be about your business so you could be in certain spaces so you're attracting certain guys that actually have value.
Wow.
But instead, at 18, 19 years old, you're thinking about the type of guy. Hey, who? How many successful relationships do we know at 19 years old? You've been with the guy for 20 plus years. When we hear it's so rare, we're like, damn.
Or they're like really, really old. They're like your grandparents or something.
Very rare. So I wouldn't want to tell no girl or no woman at 18, 19 years old to be thinking long term.
That's the time where you should be hoeing and glowing and growing.
Think with the end in mind. Say at some point, I do want to get there. Therefore, how do I want to show up today? And you just said in your last conversation from 18 to 23, go be in a hoe phase.
Yes.
So why I just heard somebody literally contradict two spaces. From 18 to 23, get your hoe on. But 18, 23, let's think about the guy that we want to be intentional with and be with. Are you hoeing? Are you trying to be with somebody forever? Pick one.
I vote for hoeing.
So
shut up, Lydia.
No, that way you listen. When you meet that guy, you're gonna know how to suck some dick.
I'm gonna say this.
You're gonna know how to pussy pop on a handstand. A wealth of sexual knowledge.
Let her go.
Sorry, go ahead.
From 18 to 23, yeah, you should have your whole phase, right? Okay, cool. But when I was hearing y'all talk, that's why I said I didn't know if I was in lining with it, because I wouldn't say, oh, yeah, talk to the guy that, you know, is in your age group, but you don't know what he got going on yet. You feel me? I just feel like if you are going to be in your whole phase and pussy pop, you shouldn't be pussy pop with somebody that don't have nothing going on. See any potential with, period. That's what I'm getting at.
So now.
So I'm saying is when I have had a one night stand or I was, I'm sorry, because he came at me a little aggressive. I had
he
to
replay
the energy.
There was smoke.
So I'm like, all right, he wanted, let me lower my gun.
She was like,
put my gun on the table. You feel me? But I guess what I'm getting at is, yeah, have your whole face. But when I give myself to someone, I'm not giving myself to a bum, period. Because at the end of the day, if something happens or I need them, I need to make sure that I can get something from them, some type of resources. Even in my hoe phase, I never was hoeing with someone that can't do nothing for me or teach me anything or do nothing for me. So I just feel like I teach women at all times, if you give your body to someone or you dealing with someone, it should be beneficial.
So what I've heard
even
you say,
when it comes to social status, like even when I'm having my, I had a one night stand or whatever, and it might have been somebody that had a higher social status than me. At the end of the day, yeah, I had a one night stand with him. I knew it wasn't going to us being nothing serious, but I know that if I need to go back in my closet and be like, yo, I need help with this podcast, I need you to help me edit, I need you to do that, it's still resources that he can give me. If need be.
Okay. You know what I'm saying? All I'm hearing her say is, instead, let's have a strategic hoe phase.
Got it.
I'm aligned with the
strategic hoe phase.
Yeah, I agree with that.
Look at that. Togetherness.
So I just don't want to hear 18, 23 year olds talking about getting married. No, you're having a strategic hoe phase.
From 15 to 18 that hit me up on my podcast, I don't think they should be talking about relationships or being serious. I don't think so. And that's what it is. But we're not going to act like, that's why I brought up women thinking about their marriage and stuff. We're not going to act like women don't put a big deal on relationships. Yeah. We think about that at a young age. Mm-hmm. And that's just what it is. When I was young, I already know my wedding going to be like, what song going to play. That's just women.
But here's
y'all don't care about relationships like that, or that's not what's on y'all mind, don't mean that that's like not.
But you know what though? And I'm not going to talk about you specifically, but it just feels so out of alignment. You telling me women women are thinking about relationships and marriages, but then when we actually take a microscope to how they show up in these spaces, none of them align to things that you would want to marry. We just talked about fucking random niggas in Miami. If you're saying that marriage is on my mind, you would not be in Miami fucking random niggas. You're fucking random niggas because marriage is not on your mind on that particular day. It's not true. It's not congruent. From 18 to 23, we just said we're gonna lie to this nigga and not tell him about our past. We're gonna have a whole phase with random niggas and we're gonna get niggas for what they worth. And then at 26, 27, we're gonna completely eradicate all that whole shit so we can show up for us.
Me using the fact that women think about their wedding day at a young age is me telling you that women put big emphasis on being in a relationship.
Okay.
That's not me saying at 18, she knows she's going to be married. It's saying that if I ever meet somebody, I have this fairy tale in my head. Mm-hmm. And that's what I'm getting at. And I'm using that as example to say that women think about relationships.
And I deal in reality.
I'm not saying at 18 she's showing up in places that she want to be a wife.
Yeah. So I deal in reality. So if I meet a nigga that says, yo, I want to fucking have a six pack, and he says, I'm thinking about it every day, but then he's going through the drive through at Wendy's, it's hard for me to take you fucking serious. Period.
Well, why again, I said that they should
think logically. Women are not. I know
exactly. That's what I'm saying. And I like reality.
Way to unpack that, guys. I'm going to get us off this one.
Is it time for a potty break?
Sure.
Yay.
Hurry up, man. So we're back. Quick little potty break.
Indeed.
Fuck with y'all little podcast. Miss Brownstone.
What's up?
What is a feminine chameleon? Is that what you call it?
I think I put female chameleon or feminine chameleon. I don't remember.
Feminine chameleon.
So basically, that is about fake femininity and a woman that kind of blends into wherever environment she's at. So when she's with women, she'll say one thing, and when she's with men, she'll say another thing, and she'll act two different ways. You get what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. But that almost sounds overall, like what pick me is.
No, pick me is completely different, and that's what we need to understand, because okay, people begin.
We'll talk about both then.
So a pick me is a woman that basically does anything to get a man's attention or use her money or agree to things that she don't want to do just so that man could be with her. That's a pick me.
Okay.
And this one, I'm basically talking about fake femininity. So fake femininity is basically you pretending to be feminine around dudes, and then you act another way around women, and then in reality, you're not feminine. And you saying that you're feminine, but femininity is more than just you wearing a dress and the way you carry, the way you look. That's what it was. So I thought we was going to talk about fake femininity.
I don't know if I've ever experienced that. So I wouldn't. Or if I have, I didn't know
so
what was happening.
Would that be, I'm going to try and make up an example and you tell me if I got it right. Mm-hmm. Right? So that would be the woman that when she's speaking to men, she's talking about, oh, she's so submissive or she can cook or, you know, whatever the fuck she thinks men want to hear.
Mm-hmm.
But then she gets around her girlfriend and is like, oh, I tell him what to do.
Mm-hmm.
He do what I say. I'm running the show. Mm-hmm. Or whatever the fuck. Is that
and
what I'm saying?
Yeah, and when okay. she will look feminine, but in reality, at her core, she's not feminine.
Right.
She's fake femininity.
Puppeteering.
Yeah.
I'm going to say, I ain't going to care. If she's actually doing those things for me, if she's holding me down like that, and then she go tell her girl she runs shit, I don't give a fuck. I would.
So have you ever, like, just talk about fake femininity as a whole. Have you ever encountered a woman who may look the part, but then when she open her mouth and the things she do, she's not?
For sure.
Like, oh, that's a dude.
So, yeah. So that's where you have to get into what really is femininity. Because I think that people, especially with Kevin Samuels and other people talking about, oh, you got to be feminine. Da, da. Men get this whole idea about femininity, but they don't really know what it is. That everybody does. It's just like the new trend to talk about. Femininity, masculine energy, betas, alphas, and nobody really knows the meaning. Femininity is not how you look. Now, does that make it look a little bit better? Yeah, but it's not about how you look. It's about the energy and the way you perceive yourself. Help me out. There we go.
I agree.
The definition is qualities or attributes regarded as characteristics of woman. Well, I was going to sex.
Yeah, okay, fair. Whatever. So it is how you perceive yourself. But I think also you can perceive yourself as feminine and still not be feminine because you don't have the correct definition in mind. So when we think about things that are attributed to a woman or qualities that are attributed to a woman, there's certain things and they may sound like made up and you might say, oh, that's not what women are today. But okay, there's an idea.
Mm-hmm.
There's an idea already. There's already a social construct of what is feminine. You know, she's probably going to be soft-spoken. She's probably going to be, I don't know, you know, kind of dainty, whatever the fuck.
Yeah,
femininity. You know, all the words that most women don't like all the time.
Femininity is like you be, well, I don't know if I ever explained it to y'all on the podcast before on here. I like to use it as a restaurant, right? So when you think of masculine energy is all about results and action. So if you are hungry, you'll go to Popeyes. All right, whatever. Just to fix the problem. When it comes to femininity, you are thinking of it as in, I'm going to go to a certain restaurant based off of the ambiance and the experience. So femininity is overall the experience of things and being in tune with your emotion. It doesn't matter how many dresses you wear, how pink you may have all this pink in your nails done. It's about at your core, are you open to expressing your feelings? Are you okay with being vulnerable? Are you okay with somebody taking a lead? Are you okay with receiving, you know? Yeah. So a lot of women look feminine, but at their core, they can be masculine. And that's how a lot of women end up with these so-called, as Willie would say, beta males, because your core energy that you're leading with and that you are is masculine.
But you know, you said something really dope and we didn't really stay on it last time. But I agree with this idea that individuals or humans have masculine energy and feminine energy. Sure, a guy has feminine energy inside of them. A woman have women and masculine and feminine. And then it's this idea of what part or what energy is going to show up with the person that you're with. Mm-hmm. And I do think that women are and men are so multifaceted that a woman can be in a space with a certain type of man and actually be expelling majority masculine energy because sure. That's what's required from that man.
For sure.
And mm-hmm. Then there are certain men who literally, and I think we talked about this before, actually put women in a feminine space. And so mm-hmm. I think that's what's really like being misconstrued is people think it's one or the other, like, oh, you're a woman, you should be feminine. No, there are places where women do have to dispel more masculine energy,
sure. Yeah.
Especially mm-hmm. when you're dealing with women who are single mothers or who hold certain spaces where they almost feel like that's how they have to show up in the world. So
you have to show up like that at work.
Right. And I guess for me personally, what I've thought about with femininity is like, I think I'm a big believer in polarity and I've realized what works for me. I realize that because of who I am, I require the opposite energy.
Yeah.
But some people don't. And I used to think I could be with anyone. There was a time in my life where I used to think any woman, she's dope and I could fuck with her, that I could be with her. It took me a while to realize, hey, this is how I want to show up in the world. This is what I would require for a woman to show up in the world. And then I actually put all the onus on myself to say, hey, what do I need to do to be able to get what I would want from that person?
When did mm-hmm. you feel like you learned that the most, though?
You said what?
When do you feel like you learned that the most?
After a failed relationship.
Mm. Yeah.
So I feel like there's relationships you get in where two people are the same. So you can get a relationship right, and you could be feminine, and that person could be feminine. That's their leading energy. Do we have masculine and feminine energy in us? Yeah. But how do you show up in the relationship? So if you show up being feminine, and that man may show up being feminine, then you're going to clash, right? Mm-hmm. So what Willie was saying basically is you're working on, like, if you're working on being more masculine and being that leader, then yeah, you have to find a feminine woman. Because in reality, two people who are the same, y'all could be together, mm-hmm. y'all could have sex, y'all could date. But when it comes time to the real nitty gritty and it being passionate and being a good experience, it has to be two different. It has to be yin and yang. Okay,
that's what I was gonna say. Yeah,
polarity. I fuck with that. I agree.
But the thing is too, like, being as though that you have both masculine and feminine energy in you. If you have a mom, a parent, a woman that is a parent, she's a single mom, right? Mm-hmm. Or she had maybe been in relationships with men where she had to lead that. She was in that masculine energy all the time. At some point, she can get stuck there. So the whole saying of, oh, the man could bring it out of you, that's not so much mm-hmm. true. Sometimes it just ain't, that's just but not you, what you lead
you
with.
Like, but that. You know what, though? And you're saying something that's super dope. I do agree it gets stuck. I actually kind of disagree that. I do think certain men could.
I do too.
But what I will say, though, in my experience is, I think certain men, their patience to even want to go through that is so low. So you're right. They get so stuck, and what it would require to get them out would require so much work. At some point, why isn't it just not easier to go find someone who naturally would?
Yeah, that's where I roll. I roll with that 100%.
So the reason why I'm saying that, if it just ain't in you, it ain't in you, right? Is because let's say I like Willie and I want to date Willie, and I know Willie wants me to be feminine, but I am masculine. I'm going to pretend, there we go into this chameleon thing, mm-hmm. I'm going to pretend to be feminine. I'm going to be fake submissive to you. I might cook and clean and take take care of this and do that just because it makes you happy. But once I get you and I sign that dotted line, nigga, if I'm sick and tired of doing that because that's not who I am masculine, I'm going to rock out with my cock out at some point. I'm going to show you who I really am.
But it's only so long fake thugs can pretend.
That's the point I'm trying to make. So at some point, it's going to reveal itself. So all that, oh, well, he can make you be feminine? No. I think we start to think that because we see how women show up with different men. So if me and... if I'm in a room and I'm single and I got two guys, one guy I might find more appealing, so I might be all, hey, with him. And the other one I might not. So I'm like, nigga, what you want? So right. That one that I'm not like that, where he just comes, he thinks, oh, she's masculine. Y'all get femininity confused with somebody being friendly to you, and that's not what it is. Yeah. It's your overall creativity, you being emotional. Are you willing to be vulnerable? Are you capable of letting somebody else take the lead? How do you show up in these environments? How do you comprehend things? How do you move? You know what I mean? Like, that's what it is.
I want to emphasize also, like, in a very obvious sense, where you just said how you move, you probably meant that differently, but like how you were saying with the examples, if I like you, I might act this way, but if I don't like you, I'm gonna say, nigga, what you doing, or whatever the fuck. Mm-hmm. When you're actually feminine, it's not going to be misconstrued that he thinks you're masculine, because you know I'm feminine. I've been compared to like a cat. I'm very feline, mm-hmm. whatever the fuck. Like, that's just what they say. Mm-hmm. But you get what I'm getting at?
Yeah. Like, we're saying,
you know, even when I reject you, even if I buck on you, I'm still womanly. I'm still feminine.
Yeah.
So when you are that, it's very hard to pretend to be otherwise. Or even if you aren't that and you want to be that, that's going to take more work than just pretending. Like, you're going to have to actually, like, adjust yourself.
The reason why I brought that up is because, like I said, with Kevin Samuels and all these people talking about femininity, men are getting it confused that because she's not friendly with you, that means she's not feminine, and that means she's masculine. That's not what femininity is. It's mm-hmm. deeper than me. Hey, how you doing? It's way deeper than that. Just like a lot of people, when I speak on my platform and I cuss like a sailor, a lot of people may see it as, oh, she's not feminine. Because I say, bitch and nigga, I'm not feminine. But if you go and pull up people that know me personally and date me, they know, oh, no, that's Vicky's, this not how she is. Mm-hmm. You know, she's in tune with her emotions. She is emotional. She wants to be seen. She wants to be cherished. She wants you to want her. I'm not controlling situations, even in friendships or relationships.
I feel like masculine women do all the same shit, too, though. I feel like masculine women, they want to be loved and all that.
They just have to understand that that's not what the man wants. The man doesn't want you giving off that masculine energy. So that's why I said you're going to have to adjust yourself.
No, some might want
that. Yeah, okay, but I'm saying in the majority, most masculine men want a feminine woman, yin and yang. I can't think of a lot of dudes that want a masculine-ass woman.
No, I disagree with that.
I said some.
There are dudes.
No, it's because it's the verbiage, right? Like, no man's going to go out and say it. But her point was right. There's some men who show up in the world where they do need a woman who's a little bit more of a leader.
Assertive.
Yes. And somebody who's going
to that's places. Normal because they're not as much.
But this is the part that I wish everybody would understand. And this is the part they didn't get in the whole red pill dialogue is it's okay
There's nothing wrong with that.
Mm-hmm. There's nothing wrong with a man being beta and a woman being more masculine. That works for them. You have to first decide how do you want to show up in the world and what do you want? And then to Ms. Brownstone's point is like at the end of the day, she may say, I want a guy that does this, this, and this. So I need to show up feminine because in order to get that type of guy, he's more than likely going to want these character traits from me. Mm-hmm. But she may say, hey, I want to be in a situation where I don't have to do none of that shit. She may say what I really want in my dynamic is I want a guy who's more passive or a guy that I can, you know, take charge, or I want to be making decisions with them. And there's nothing wrong with that.
Nothing at all.
Mm-hmm. And we shouldn't even clown guys who are, you know, beta in that regard. Like, that's good for them.
Everybody has to find their yin and yang. Like I said, if he's masculine but not as much, he's more in tune with his feminine, he might want a woman that's more in tune with her masculine. But either way, it's going to balance. It has to balance.
But this is where the part that I think always got put in the Kevin Samuels dialogue, because we only saw the clips, is he was telling everyone, hey, what do you want from a man? Facts. The woman would describe a man what that has alpha characteristics. And then he would say, well, if this is the guy you want, the guy that's got to make $250,000 a year, he's got to be 6'2", he's got to be chiseled up and all that kind of stuff. He would give you the statistics. He would tell you the likelihood of finding that person. And then he would say, in order to find this person through his own data collection, here's some of the traits that they would want. Yeah. And the woman went,
Like, what? He wouldn't want me for me?
Yeah.
Yeah, no. Yeah, I hear you.
And so I just think in this whole like feminine thing, like to what Ms. Brownstone was saying, is it should just be based on like, I do agree with her. It should be what is natural to you. Mm-hmm. I don't even want a woman who's not, that's not natural to me, because to your point, they're going to eventually fall back to the mean. They're going to fall back to who they truly are. Mm-hmm. It has to be a concerted decision on that's how I want to show up in the world. I agree with you.
And to Willie's initial point, sometimes the world has hardened the woman to the point where she feel like
and
she got it.
And that's what I was about to say, and I didn't want to go off track, no, go ahead, but it was in my mind is that when we were talking about like being a single parent and you always have to make decisions for yourself and you get stuck in that energy, the crazy part about it all is our childhood and our trauma is what really forces us to lead with that energy. Like me, at my core, I am feminine. But however, I grew up in environments and around certain people where I have to come off as this hard and exterior kind of thing. You know what I'm saying? But in reality, that's not who I am. So only people that get close enough to me would know that, oh, snap, she mushy. But when I'm on camera, when I'm talking, when I'm around people, when I'm doing business, I come off like I'm that nigga. But I'm not. You know what I'm saying? So sometimes based off your trauma and what you have experienced or just sometimes even your parents can have that effect on you. For instance, right? Women always look for somebody like they dad, right? Supposedly. But then you have women who have men that were not that ideal man, have fathers that wasn't that ideal man.
For sure.
So they got to, they get programmed to, okay, I don't want this, I want that. So, you know what I'm saying? Like, that end up making you be more masculine because maybe your dad wasn't that kind of dad. So now you got to program yourself like, I don't need a nigga for shit because at some point, this my daddy ain't even show up for me. So now I'm in that energy 24/7 and I'm stuck there. So it is what you are at your core, yeah. But there's a lot of things that happen to women and men that make them become or try to be look at as someone else. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? But if it's not in you, it's not in you.
But the only thing I would probably not agree with, if it's not in you, and this is just probably from me just getting older, is I think there are some women or just people in my life, I want to hold spaces for people who have an evolving mindset. Mm-hmm. So I do believe in, and this is just my human idea, that there are people out there that are probably, like you said, hardened on a certain status, but or a certain state. But I at least want to give them the space to say that there's evolvement that can happen with those persons.
I was about to say from my own.
That's just a human thing. It's not even just like a. It's not like a feminine masculine. It's like I don't want to always say that is who you are. You cannot change. Yeah. I want to have a more like broad like, hey, like at least with the woman I'm with, I want us both to be able to get to a point where like, hey, Ms. Brownstone, me and you, we're here now, but let's leave space for us to evolve and maybe change our minds on things or to develop certain things, and let's continue to maintain our core like connection, but let's leave the space for us growth. To grow.
Yeah.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I agree. Yeah.
Okay, so you think it could be something that's worked on?
Yeah. I'm leaving space for growth. I am going to say that. And I do think that, but I would not make a decision off that growth. So that's where we do agree. I don't want to be with somebody who's masculine and say, I'm going to change you. No,
yeah, no,
I'm not doing that. Yeah. But I'm just saying I do want to leave room for areas of growth for people in general. But you are right. Yeah. You should only commit to based on current state.
And we gotta allow people that time to get through that trauma. And
yeah,
all
yeah.
All this stuff.
Yeah, but, of course.
But here's what I've and this is, I have not answered this question, but I always ask myself how much is a guy that didn't create the trauma responsible for helping you get through that trauma? I don't know that there's a right or wrong. I don't know.
Zero. It's not my job. It's not my responsibility.
I feel like there's
your responsibility. You can be there and support and help and go through it, but your responsibility?
If I love you and I want to be with you, and there's parts of trauma that don't hinder me to be with you, but you still have dealt with it, I do think from a masculine perspective, if I'm taking on this leadership space with you, I do feel like some of that's your responsibility.
This is where me and Willie almost never disagree.
Okay.
I disagree.
So,
but I'm gonna help you because it's not my responsibility. Responsibility means it's like, yo, let me get you.
So remember, we define an organization as when two or more gather. Mm-hmm. Me and you together, we're an organization. Mm-hmm. I want to be the leader. Being a leader means I'm gonna be responsible for some things that I don't necessarily want to be responsible for. And I'm the leader of my household. Mm-hmm. And there are some things about you that are not the best or things you're dealing with. I do feel like as the leader, I'm gonna be responsible to tap in into certain things and try to help you through it because I'm the leader and I want to be a leader every single day.
Responsibility
can come in multiple ways. Responsibility can be, let's help you get therapy. Responsibility can be, hey, I want to show up for you because I know you have this particular trauma, so I'm going to be more mindful of that. Responsibility comes in many form factors.
But bring the water to the horse, Willie.
No, but I see, but this is
I feel,
what this
I, no, so after him saying that, I feel where he's coming from. I just call that aiding.
Yes. Yeah, but what I'm saying is I just want to be clear that I want to take this leader thing serious because I'm going to show up that way, and it's, some people may not want to deal with you truly being a leader. I want to be a leader at all times. I want to be respected as a leader. So I'm not going to pick and choose when I'm that. That's all I'm saying. I'm going to be congruent.
I agree with that. I agree with that.
But you can't make me change.
It's not about making, but being a leader saying, hey, you.
But it's your responsibility, and you're going to feel like you failed if you do not achieve certain responsibility.
There's going to be things with trauma that's going to
More semantics.
It's going to evolve. No, it's going to evolve through time. Yeah. Trauma is not a one day thing.
No, it's not.
Trauma could be if me and her are together and she's dealing with trauma, we may work on this particular trauma for years.
Yeah.
And I'm not saying, I'm not going to say I'm a failure because trauma is not eradicated. Trauma is going to evolve. Trauma may start off at 60%, it may go to 50%, 40%, 30%. And then you could almost feel like you're healed. And then I might come in the house and do some crazy shit and it can literally spark all new trauma. I got to be understanding, you know, as a leader that I'm choosing this. I'm choosing to be in this space with you. And if I'm choosing that I don't want to deal with your trauma, then I shouldn't be in a relationship with you in the first place.
I'm very transparent, right? So I don't know if y'all know that. I don't know if y'all listen to my podcast. If y'all haven't, go check out She Knows.
Except
just saying.
About the past. Go ahead.
Shut up. What he was just talking, you know what I thought of? Is because in some point, I get what you're saying, because I've been in a relationship with a guy, right? And I thought that I was healed from, like, how can I say this? So my dad is alcoholic, right? So I've been in a relationship with a guy and I thought that I was healed from the stuff I might have experienced with my father being an alcoholic. And we get in a relationship and this man does something. He comes to my house one night and he's drunk as hell. And it just triggered it back from me. So now I'm back in that same space. You get what I'm saying? So sometimes you could think that you're over it, but you're really not. It takes that one thing that he might have done that would trigger you back. So maybe in some type of way, I get what he's saying about him being responsible for it. Because if I bring it up to his attention and he cares about me that much and he wants to be a leader, at some point he's going to try to help you, you know. But that doesn't mean that, oh, he got to keep trying. Like, no, if you try to get me help, if it doesn't work, okay, it don't work. Right. But at least I could say that my man cared enough to try. Because when it comes to providing, you're providing more than what's in your pocket, right?
Sure. And Ms. Brownstone, so here's my question, though. So now we're, because you brought up a really good point. I feel like I'm responsible. I'm with you. And let's say over times of me trying, the trauma is still insurmountable. The person still has a trauma, so I can't ignore it. So then the question is, does staying still mean that I'm willing to try? Or do I leave because leaving is really me saying I don't want to deal with it no more? Because it's hard to say I'm going to stay but no longer try to help you because you still have it. Mm-hmm. So what should I do?
I'm going to tell you, Willie, I don't know, baby. You're going to have to figure that out. I can't help you. I don't know.
That makes me feel as if the other person's not trying as hard. And they might be, but you're saying it's your responsibility. That means, in my brain, the person that says I'm responsible for something normally takes more of the weight of it,
right?
Whether or not this is
true, that's what I'm thinking.
But what I'm saying is, if you've been trying so long and you think that by now it should be lesser and I can't deal with this no more, maybe they weren't willing to work as hard as you were on it. And if that is the case, then you should leave.
Because
they are not working as hard as they should be on fixing their own shit. So, and it is their shit. No,
and I agree with you. That's what I'm saying, though. But I feel like if I'm choosing, because we all agree that relationships are a choice.
100%.
And I'm choosing to be with you. That means I'm choosing to be with all of you and also to help and be responsible for the traumas that we have laid out and share in the space. And what I'm saying is, at some point, with any trauma, flaws, and like, even this is going to sound sad, people are not going to like it. Even if you had a terminal illness, if I got to a point where I'm saying, hey, this is too much for me, it's too heavy, I always reserve the right to leave.
Yes.
And I'm saying is, but if I decide to continue to stay, I'm saying I'm staying with all of you.
Of course. I'm saying
if me and this person is together, I can't pick and choose parts of you that I want to take on. That's not fair to her.
That's what I was saying.
Yeah, that's what I was saying originally. So my answer actually, it was like how I look at it, I feel like as long as you're there, you're responsible. The day that you really don't want to be responsible and you just say, I don't give a fuck or I'm tired of working, I think you should bounce.
Mm-hmm. Like I said, semantics, because I think we all agree with everything except maybe the responsible part.
Are you worried that when you leave, they'll look at you like, oh, he doesn't care anymore?
I'm actually a huge believer in leaving when it's too much. Mm. I believe in that shit. I don't care if we've been together 5 years, 10 years, 2 days. I think when it comes too much and you're not in it, bounce. And I would tell a woman that's with me, you lay over me and you look at me and be like, yo, I don't like this nigga no more. Pack your shit and go. Or I'll pack mine. Never stay somewhere where you no longer want to be there. Never. Yeah. Never.
Right. So if that responsibility of the trauma is too much for you, then, honestly, before you attach yourself to that person, you should have a better idea of it.
Bingo.
Don't get into the relationship and then be surprised. Oh shit, they're fucked up. Like, you should know that before you attach themselves.
Come out agreed. On the first.
But that's through building friendship and connection. Mm-hmm. And this is what's really cool about relationships. In my opinion, they always have a get off sign. They always have an exit ramp. They do. Mm-hmm. Even marriages have exit ramps. You can always exit. Mm-hmm. Nobody's holding a gun to no one's head.
That's not necessarily like Netflix.
True.
I mean, maybe there's probably some abusive relationships where somebody
unless that, their head. Yeah. Except for
but if they are, call right. this number. Put it on the screen.
Yes, put it on the screen. Domestic violence hotline.
Edit anything. No. Don't do any editing.
Whatever.
I don't know the number, but anyway.
You get the Google.
Last one. Do you guys want to define what an alpha male is?
No.
Now I want y'all to define it. Because my definition might not be the right definition.
Let's hear it from the men.
Yeah, since y'all so much alphas.
I'm that because that's what people see me as. I'm Kadeem.
What is a alpha male?
I think that's it right there. You are you.
No,
that's
that ain't it.
The fuck it.
That's it.
Because everybody ain't Kadeem, so that means everybody ain't alpha.
Well, obviously, but I'm talking about the security he has in himself. He said, I'm an alpha because I am what the fuck I already am.
What characteristics do you have that you consider yourself an alpha?
I don't. I have the people call that's me that. Question. I don't know that. That's why I say ask y'all.
I'm an answer, Willie? But I want
yeah, to. Yeah, when I think of the word alpha, I just think these are people who usually show up in spaces are usually leaders. I don't care if it's like duck, duck, goose, if it's at work. They usually are people who tend to rise to the top. They're somebody who kind of is more polarizing. They like to be in control of certain things. They're someone who'd like, when the spaces that they show up, they tend to take up a lot of space. These are people who are sometimes aggressive, sometimes overly aggressive. Sometimes they're people who I think are just kind of sometimes do want to lead. They kind of are my way or the highway type people. These are people that are generally, in my opinion, like have like alpha characteristics. They're the word almost like the alpha of the pack. They tend to even, I don't care if it's just, even at church, they tend to somewhat find their way in the front. They tend to find their way in the front and they're volunteers and at work. They're just people who just naturally have like a leadership style to them. They have a polarization to them. They're not subtle. They're just, and I'm not even saying that alpha is always positive. I'm saying sometimes alpha can be bad, but I'm saying these are just guys who just have like a very aggressive like space. They just, that's how they show up. Like, that's what I think of as an alpha.
See, I mean,
problem solve.
You saw what?
And problem solve.
Yeah, they tend to be more solution based. They tend to be they are someone who just like and even for me when I was going through this whole introspection about what I wanted, I started to realize like in all the spaces that I was holding, I was constantly always like always matriculating upward. I was always like saying, hey, like I tend to always lead in a lot of spaces that I'm in, or if I'm not vested, I don't lead at all. Like if I'm not bought in, I'm just not there. And so when I thought about a relationship, that means I have to be invested. I have to want it. I'm more than likely going to want things my way. I actually realized, because I start realizing I really don't want a lot of things to be negotiation. I don't want a lot of things to be, hey, what if we do this, we do that? I kind of want to be like, hey, babe, this is what we're going to do.
And I think that's where I have the problem with the whole alpha male thing, is because I think that people get in their mind that because you are the leader, that it's always your way. In my mind, I believe that an alpha male, when in a relationship, when he makes the decision, he's going to make the best decision with everyone in mind, his wife and his children. You know what I'm saying? Instead of it just being whatever I want, whatever I
go. He didn't say that. Go that way.
I should have prefaced that.
I thought that was understood.
Yeah, no, it was. She hit me with a semantic.
It's not understood, because that's the problem that I have with a lot of men thinking that they're alphas. And with the content that's being produced out here, okay, not being discriminating, men are thinking that, oh, if I'm an alpha, it's what I say goes. I don't care about your feelings, and you have to just cater to me.
This is why I had a hard time answering the question, though, because to me, it's like when you're the alpha, you're revered as such too. So the people that's
people
behind you,
they're
gonna follow you. They're gonna listen to you. They're gonna know, yo, the collective is in mind when I said what I said. I don't have to double back and tell you, well, I thought about you and you. No, nigga, you knew what the fuck I was saying when I said it.
And what I'm saying again, I'm going to say this for the, like in an organization. Yes, you can always go down in the organization if there's 1,100 and you could take feedback. We can write little surveys. We could say, hey, what do you think about it?
That's to make you feel good.
But ultimately, in any successful organization, the buck has to stop with one person.
For sure.
And somebody has to make the decision for the collective. If I'm sharing a space with a woman and we decide to actually live together, do business together, get married, ultimately, I got to make the decision. And you should already know by being with me, you've already believed that I'm going to make the decision mm-hmm. based on the collective. So it's not like a, hey, woman, get up and fucking roll around and do jumping jacks. That's not a leader's not going to do that anyway. Mm-hmm. You've already know that when I make a decision, I'm always thinking about the collective. My job ultimately is the success of the organization.
Facts.
And this is the thing: when we have leaders and these guys are failures, they're results oriented. They don't be like, hey, CEO, did you think about everybody when you made all your decisions? No, they're going to say, how much did you earn? How much did you bring in? Were you a success or not?
Facts.
And so if I know if I'm in a marriage, at the end of the day, we talked about this before in the pod. If me and you are together. And we're on the side of the street. Nobody goes, yo, what did she do to mess put Facts. Them on the streets?
Never.
They're going to look at me. Yeah. Therefore, I'm going to make decisions based on, hey, I got to make sure I have a family and I got to make sure we're never on the street. So if I make the decision where we're going to move from Grassfield to South Norfolk so that we can make sure our bills are paid, if that means I got to work 3 jobs and you're never going to see me. My job is the results of my family and we're results based. So an alpha is always going to say, it's on me.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. It's
on
me.
And the people with you going to know.
And so if I know it's on me, I'm sorry. I might ask you, which house in South Norfolk would you desire? Then I'll let you know if that's in our price range. But at the end of the day, you're going to go where I want to go. When I was young and crazy, that used to be one of the first questions I used to ask women. Yo, if I told you we're going to go live in a box, are you down?
You're gonna go with what's best for the collective.
What's best for the organization,
the group?
Then you should say that. That's what I'm saying. That when people are hearing this, these men are getting it messed up because you're saying you're gonna go where I say we're gonna go. What's best for me? It's not about you and your alpha. You think of everyone, right? And you make the lead.
No, he's saying that he understands that. You're saying
I'm saying
that she wants to make sure that while we're on this platform, we make. That known.
That's the reason why I wanted to talk about it.
That's the reason why I wanted to talk about it.
Most platforms are, you know, extra on the machismo.
I guess here's the difference. And maybe this is just a 35-year-old version of me. I'm the person that's so less likely to be in a relationship that while I'm not in a relationship, it's always about me. And if I do make a decision to be with you, it's already assumed that you've done something to now I'm always going to think about the collective. If it's my way or the highway, that's a single nigga talking. Mm-hmm. So it shouldn't matter.
Facts.
So if you're really that dude, it's so by the time you get into a relationship, it's already assumed that I've let go of that selfish mentality and I'm thinking about the collective.
Yeah.
If you're dealing with young niggas who still think it's my way or the highway and I'm in a relationship, those are the guys who don't need to be consuming the content anyway. They're already fucked up.
And they might, bro, but they, you know, they trying to figure out how
to. Yeah, you don't know. Because I think you should be single as fuck while you're thinking about just yourself.
Yeah.
Then you don't have to deal with that. You don't have to even make, you don't even have to deal with somebody telling you talk this way because I'm single as fuck. Talk however I want to talk.
Big facts.
What was I about to say?
Girl, I don't know. I asked you what you were going to say.
Oh, I was going to say that I feel as though real alphas don't shout that they're alphas.
That's why I didn't know what to say. I'm saying the people around you gonna revere you as that. They gonna see you like, oh no, he, you know what I'm saying?
But I noticed that with the content that's being out now for these men, every man wants to be a alpha and they have this idea of an alpha that is not really what an alpha is. So I wanted men to sit here and talk about it.
Okay, I got you.
Just so it can be known.
It's a gross miscorrection, right? Because of feminism and all that extra shit that's been going on. All the I don't need a nigga for this. I don't need a nigga for that. So now men are trying to figure out where do I get my power back at? Mm-hmm. Where do I fit in this dynamic? And a lot of times you'll see the content, red pill, blue pill, purple pill, whatever the fuck you watching, you looking at it and you're
purple
like, I'm more in the middle. It's a little bit of everything for me.
Yeah. Yeah.
But it's like, yo, you gotta earn that. Your girl gotta look at you and be like, oh, he got me.
Exactly.
Like Willie said, now we're in this space and she know like, no, whatever I'm doing is for the group. You know what I'm saying? And it's always going to be times where she's going to chime in. She's going to have her say about this, that, and the third. But if I don't like, she know if I say I don't want to do that, that's for the group. It's for the betterment of the group.
Yeah, and the fact that you came to her to ask, mm-hmm. she should feel respected anyway because you do call the shots.
Like
she
said.
So if I considered you as my one, I'm a dude. I considered your thoughts. I asked mm-hmm. you how you felt about mm-hmm. something. I said, hey, what do you think?
Mm-hmm.
That's already you. That's all that's required to do.
My homegirl, little cousin, they was in the airport, right? And she said, can you hold my purse? And this little nigga said, I'm an alpha. Alphas don't hold purses.
Oh, true.
That's corny. Like, y'all have this.
And I don't hold person. I will hold anything Caitlyn has.
But you know what?
But the thing I'm trying to say is this it's this confusion.
I said you lying.
Of it's all about me. I'm the leader. I have to say so. And that's not really what Alpha is. Like I said, he makes a decision to put everybody in mind. And just because you're Alpha don't mean you ain't a gentleman. Like, well, when do we get this?
That's what I'm about. But I'm not walking through the airport with Caitlyn's purse. But I'll hold it for a brief second.
Yeah, it was for a brief second.
But I'm not walking through the airport with her purse.
No, but what it sounds like is we live in this short clip, short social media culture where people only are extracting the things that they want. Right.
Yep.
Because at the end of the day, everything that I've understood as this whole dynamic of Red Pill Alpha has always been about what are you doing to be better for you as
exactly.
a man? It has nothing to do with the woman. My it's always been, if you're an alpha, it's like, what are you doing? How are you showing up in the world? So that when you do decide to bring a woman into your experience, you don't have to say it. So I've always lived in like, hey, how are you bettering yourself? Like, how do you want to show up in the world so that when you do meet a woman, you don't have to say it. She's experiencing that. She's naturally going to fall in
it.
Don't
see it.
So I agree. So I do agree with you.
She knows. She knows. Just make sure you put that in there for the podcast.
100%.
She knows. Yeah. Make sure you follow me. But
it is a weird little toxic place low key where the red pill dudes is out here.
I think
screaming.
All you got to do is just say it. I'm an alpha male. That's how we hear
a lot of them niggas
I'm
be
an alpha.
Hurt. They be hurt,
the fuck you know.
And we gonna get into that. But a lot of them be hurt, and at some point you gotta let that hurt go, baby. Mm-hmm. Especially if you wanna, you know.
You said what? Well, we on here don't say there's nothing. If that's what that woman needs and wants, and this is what fits for her, there's nothing wrong with that.
I said, yeah, we said that.
Why can't you be both? Why can't you have both characteristics and play it when you play whatever hand is necessary
when needed?
Just cause I don't like that one, mama. If I'm the CEO, sometimes you're going to delegate somebody. There's a COO, there's a CFO, there's other important roles.
Of strength when you know that you're
needed.
Sometimes you have to step back and be considered a beta. You may not be that all the time.
You're probably beta in the decisions of the household where Caitlyn rules the castle.
No, but I
I don't think that makes you a beta.
No,
it doesn't. She's stronger in another point.
It doesn't. And then Ms. Brownstone said it. You're still gonna fall back to what your natural state is. Yeah, you're gonna have areas where you're gonna follow. The captains or the leaders of an army at one point was a follower. You're always gonna have areas of like you say, you're gonna play to strengths. But at the end of the day, we still have natural states. We still have states where we tend to over index in. And so even in a house dynamic, there's gonna be times where if Caitlyn wants to pick out the drapes, we can call that beta where Kadeem's going to take a step back and let her pick out the drapes or whatever the case may be. But again, at the collective, with any organization, there is no parity in successful organizations. At every success, there's somebody's name at the top of the awning. And that's all I'm saying is, and so naturally for that person at the top of the awning, he still has got to be the person that when it really, really counts, has that energy that you're going to trust to help and lead. But to your point, you're definitely right.
Does that make you beta for, like, when it comes to Sienna, right? I step back. I'm like, yo, you're with her more than me. You delegate. Like, I wanted to give her melatonin for the flight. I told this story before. And Caitlyn did the research and was like, nah, melatonin ain't it right now.
Yeah.
And I ain't say, nah, fuck that. I don't want her screaming on the plane. I roll with what she said. Yeah. That don't make me beta. That makes me smart, nigga.
Right.
She's the one that does all those things.
That's why I said this content that is out is going to be a problem. We need to explain stuff before we just be out here pushing this shit.
I agree.
Because if a little nigga tell me he ain't holding my purse, we're going to have a problem.
The CEO at the company don't know how to do everything.
I agree.
Yeah, the CEO at the company is not the best coder at Apple. You know what I mean?
Right.
Tim Cook. Yeah, you can't do it all. It's impossible.
Yeah, you can't do it all.
You know what I'm saying? There's tasks, you know, when our mortgage was switched from this company to this company, she handled all that. Just send me the information.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? That's a team effort. But, you know, if some real shit happens, she can be like, hey, Kadeem, something happening. And I'm going to step up. I'm going to do what the fuck I'm supposed to do.
Right.
That's what it's supposed to like, come on, man. I had a different story, but I'm not going to tell that. I'm going to let that one marinate.
That was good, y'all. Y'all did what I wanted y'all to do. I'm proud of y'all.
Thanks. We glad we could help. This one went kind of long. I might break this one up into two. We're at 2 hours. A little break in the middle.
I feel like I redeemed myself, like, personally.
You did, because you was being a drunk. Everybody in the comments. Hold on. I'm going to outro this. I know you guys are here for Ms. Brownstone. Hit subscribe and stop commenting that. Leave a comment about the video. We know you're here for her. Comment about her great content.
See, you know what the problem is, though? Because you said Miss Brownstone's the guest. You didn't say Miss Brownstone is a part of just another podcast.
I've been waiting for Miss Brownstone to say it on her podcast.
I've been said on my podcast. You ain't you are? The past three episodes,
I listened said to it all on my podcast. You know,
okay, clearly you didn't listen you know to the past three.
Miguel and all that.
Shut the fuck up. But yeah, so I mean, if y'all want to call me a guest, hey, but I'll be back. I thought I was a part
home,
of it.
Part of the show.
Family.
Family, Miss Brownstone. Make sure you subscribe. Where we at? We powering up over here. I got more sound effects. I don't know. I fuck with that little podcast.
I fuck with y'all little podcast.
Look at Sarah. She's like, what is happening? This has been great. Thank you for y'all coming in here on a what's today? Saturday? Saturday
yes,
night.
Saturday. You know what I mean? Church was originally on Saturday though, so y'all did y'all a good deed today.
No doubt.
You know, I'm the alpha of this show.
And I'm the beta of the show.
I appreciate y'all. Make sure you hit subscribe and we out.